The GHSA State Championships presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to buckle up, Georgia, as we welcome you back to Center Park Stadium in downtown Atlanta. It's the big granddaddy of them all, the Class 7A Championship, as the Mill Creek Hawks take on the unbeaten Carrollton Trojans. And good Saturday night. I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former Auburn Tigers All-American, NFL first-round draft pick, and 15-year pro Wayne Gandy. And Wayne, Mill Creek in the state championship game for the first time in their 19-year school history. Carrollton has all the history on their side. This is their 14th state championship game, first since 2013, going after their eighth state championship and their first since 1998.
It's exciting in the stadium. I'm excited up in the booth, Matt. I just want to see these great players, Caleb Downs, Juju Lewis. Let's kick the ball off.
Should be a spectacular matchup. Let's start with Mill Creek, 13-1 on the season. Their only blemish, a loss to then number one, three-time state champion Buford. They have rebounded from that to demolish the competition since then. Got a spectacular roster of talent, starting with the number one player in the state, the number one safety in the nation, the number 11 overall national prospect. And it's his birthday. Caleb Downs committed to Alabama.
The five-star dominant player, defense, offense, special teams. He's just a big play waiting to happen. He checks all the boxes, lives up to billing. And I guess, Matt, you're right. All we can say is happy birthday, Mr. Downs.
Offensive side of the ball, the explosive wide receiver, Mikel Wood, three-star wide receiver, committed to Eastern Michigan. He's been lightning in the playoffs.
Electric with big hands down the field. They're a deep threat, a go-to guy that they must get this ball to early. He has 13 touchdowns, averaging 19 yards a catch. He is a primetime player.
Back to the defensive side of the ball, and another four-star, Jamal Anderson, son of Dirty Bird, committed to Clemson.
6'4", 202, plays in that middle linebacker position. A lot of teams try to run away from him. The thing he's done in the playoffs, started to rush the passer, a great pass rusher, and they're going to need that tonight against Mr. Young Superstar, Juju Lewis.
All right, the story on Carrollton, 14-0 in the season, bumped up from 6A to 7A, unranked, something that head coach Joey King says was motivation for this team this season. They brought in Joey King for this reason, to get them back to the promised land, and here they are. They've got a freshman quarterback, Juju Lewis, number one freshman quarterback in the nation. He's got a huge college football and pro football future in front of him.
A true sensation is Mr. Lewis. Can make all the throws, silky smooth, calm under pressure, plays more like a fifth-year senior in a college program. Quick release, spreads the ball around, future superstar in Juju.
And he's got a running back in Bryce Hicks, who doesn't have all the stars, but for my money, the most underrated player in the state.
The best player on this football team at the moment for Carrollton. 22 rush touchdowns, 8 receiving touchdowns. They count on him. He is the motor to this offense.
And on the defensive side of the ball, they got Jacob Levy. He's number 2 in the nation in wrestling. It helps him on the defensive line.
5'10", 220, undersized, but very strong. Plays with great leverage. Will need to make some big plays, but he's going up against Aiden Benfield, so he has his work cut out for him tonight.
It's the Trojans and the Hawks, the grand finale. We've been waiting for this one, and so has Nikki Noto-Palmer, who's down on the sideline.
Hey, guys, you know, when we talked to Coach Joey King this week, we asked him, Coach, did you genuinely think Carrollton would make it this far into this season? And he said, I got to be honest, I knew we were going to be better than last year, but it was a shock to us that we came into the season unranked. He said Buford was ranked number 1 this year. They lost to them in the semifinals 21-6 last year, and they got no love. He said, we have used that as internal motivation all season long, and here they are. They've got two big-time All-State playmakers in Juju and Bryce. We'll be talking about them all weekend. Oh, yeah, they've got the coach of the year among all classifications and Joey King. He said, we're going to come out and we're going to play hard, not because it's the most important game of the season, but because it's the next one. And we preach that 1-0 mentality all season long. They're 14-0. They've got a chance to go 15-0 tonight for the 7A state championship game. Matt.
And how about this? They have not had a perfect, unbeaten, untied season since back in the early 60s when Charlie Grisham, the legendary Charlie Grisham, led them to a state championship at 13-0. And how legendary is Charlie Grisham? The stadium in Carrollton is named after him. Perhaps if Joey King wins tonight, the field will be named after him. So electricity in the air as we are ready to get started. Jacob Ulrich has it teed up and ready to go. All-state kicker, GPB Sports all-state kicker, ready to get it going here. And Takari Lipscomb standing deep for the Trojans. The opening kickoff, as you know, is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seat belts save lives. Kind of a misty rain starting to fall here as we're ready to kick off at 7:06 Eastern time. The 7A state championship game is underway. And Ulrich kicks it 68 yards to the back of the end zone, so the Trojans will start at the 20-yard line.
Juju Lewis, the young freshman right there, superstar. But everything starts with the run game. This offensive line, Kai Gift Dudley up front, Andrew Walker, Bryce Hicks, the running back. They're going to have to keep this offense balanced to let this young man right there go to work tonight.
You saw the numbers for the ninth grader, Juju Lewis, 22 offers, including Georgia, Alabama, and Tennessee. He'll have his choice of schools where he wants to go, and we're still 4 years away from that. First and 10. Bryce Hicks on the first carry of the game. Barely gets back to the line of scrimmage. Nick Maxey, the defensive end, making the stop for the Hawks.
The North Greenville commit, Nick Maxey. Big penetration, 88 right there. Coming in, making a tackle, and this defensive front. Both well, Maxey, Denick. Good pressure up front. Only a three-man line playing that 3-4 defense, but great penetration.
Ball batted down by Jamal Lewis. Let's take a look at the Regents Bank starting lineup for the Carrollton Trojans up front. Dudley, Sizemore, Walton, Sims, and Walker. Hicks is the running back. Odom is a four-star junior wide receiver. Childers, Lipscomb, and White. Lineup outside as well.
Great job that last play by Anderson. Playing off the edge, long and rangy. Now back in pass coverage.
Ball batted down again. Nick Denick, two passes knocked down on the opening series. Josh Lovelady, you saw him, the head coach. He's been there all 19 years of the program history.
Trying to get out into the screen game and get that ball to Caleb Odom. Nice read there by Denick, seeing the quarterback and the screen develop, getting that big paw up and knocking the ball down.
Fourth season as the head coach, 39-12. He originally came there as an assistant to the first ever coach, Shannon Jarvis. And the kick is away from Caleb Downs and going to roll dead at the 31.
Something tells me that'll be a common play tonight on the punt coverage team. Keep the ball away from Caleb Downs.
That was a 48-yard punt. And our first chance to see the Hawks on offense, Hayden Clark, who separated his shoulder in the victory against Milton last Friday night in the semifinals. They took him out second quarter. They've got it wrapped up tight. He would not miss this start. He's a three-year starter for Mill Creek. Cam Robinson going to get 3 yards. That's another big story in the Mill Creek storyline this season. Here's the offensive line brought to you by Regents Bank. Bothwell, Banfield, who's the bell cow. Marshall, Sheen, and Murphy up front. K. Cam Robinson and Caleb Downs are running backs. Jenkins, the son of Michael Jenkins, the former Falcon. Wood and Mullins is also a budding star. Right up the middle, Cam Robinson off to the races. Can they catch him? Cut back, touchdown, Mill Creek.
Cam Robinson, a special back who's put on a special performance this season. We talk so much about this young man moving over from the slot to play running back, and now he's showing you the speed. Watch Mikael Wood right here do a great job hustling for his teammate, making sure no one runs him down from behind, just getting some interference. Cam Robinson, big playability all night long.
PAT by Ulrich up and in. And a 7-0 lead for Mill Creek less than 90 seconds into the game.
Great blocking in that middle there by Marshall and Banfield, the center and guards. Just zone read in the middle. No one touches. And when you let this young man out in the open field, he's just going to be hard. And right there, that Woods effort is what epitomizes this Mill Creek team and why they are so special.
That's one of the things you got to love about high school football. As you see, Cam Robinson score his 19th rushing touchdown this season. In high school football, sometimes you open the year with question marks you don't know. They had no idea Cam Robinson was going to be the running back that he's become this year.
Definitely answered the bell, answered the call for his coach. Questioned his size playing at that running back position. Never can put question his speed and ability. And that's the thing. Not afraid, Cam Robinson, to run between the tackles.
So after a three and out, Carrollton receiving another kickoff here. Kelvin Hill, number one, standing deep. We'll see if Ulrich gives him an opportunity to return. He will not. This one's going to go 69 yards. Okay. Wayne, let's take a look at the Breda Pest Management keys to the game when the Trojans are on offense.
Juju Lewis and this receiving core are going to have to make some big plays down the field. This Hawk secondary prides themselves on matching up man-to-man, and you have to exploit that. For Mill Creek, you got to get some pressure. We've seen early on in that first drive the ends and Anderson and Dennett get their hands up. You got to get this young man, Julian Lewis, off the spot and get some pressure on him.
Lewis up top, trying a back shoulder throw there to Caleb Odom, and it's incomplete.
Caleb Odom, a special kind of player, one of those tweeners right now, receiver, tight end. You can see the height difference he has on Trajan Greco, number three, who's listed at 6'1". Caleb Odom is 6'6", about 210 pounds, a prime-time junior, four-star.
Wayne, when you called him a tweener, I thought you meant between tight end and power forward. Second down and 10. Right up the middle. And don't let the size of Bryce Hicks fool you. 5'8", 165. He will run tough between the tackles as we take a look at Mill Creek on defense. Brought to you by Regions Bank. Maxie, Ankrum, and Denick up front. A.G., Anderson, Mullins, and Anglin are the linebackers. Content, Greco, Downs, and Patterson. And Greco is another guy at corner who has progressed by leaps and bounds this season. Run by Jamon Evans.
In this kind of game against this defense, I think that's what this Trojan offense is going to have to do. They're going to have to let Hicks, Evans, and this offensive line dictate the tempo. Good job out on the edge. Edge blocking key. Hard running there by Jamal Evans, the senior.
First and 10, ball at the 30. Hicks gets the ball again. He gets swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage. Bryce Bothwell, Nick Maxie, Langston Agee, all in on that tackle.
Tremendous penetration up the field there by Dennett and Maxie. A nice job of Langston Agee coming off the corner, number 30, to make that tackle.
Second down and 11. Juju Lewis fires quickly to Odom, steps out of bounds at the 35. They pick up five.
Nice job. Good route there by Odom. Just an out route on Trajan Greco. And as you alluded to, Matt, his production this year, along with content, allowed this defense to play more man, and his secondary rounded it out with Downs and Patterson on that back end.
It's third down and five. Lewis fires, first down catch. That's Childers up to the 45-yard line.
Nice job there by the freshman. Spreading out. They're in man defense. Working that slot right there to Childers. Being patient.
Yeah, and Childers has had a great season. When you're concentrating on everybody else, they got Childers waiting there to catch a pass. First and 10.
You can see this Hawk defense out on the corners. They're up. They will challenge you in man-to-man defense.
Lewis going to throw back. Got a man open and could not connect with Kai Kofer.
Good job. Wheel route here by Kofer. And this is just where Juju Lewis would have wanted to lead his receiver up the field. You have to throw him open, lead him down the field, let him run into the ball, threw it behind him, but he had at least two steps there on the linebacker.
Kai Kofer missed five games this season with injury. He was able to rebound from that to have a great offensive season. It's second down and 10. Running the ball so far tonight has been a no-go. That was Jamon Evans again with his second carry.
Cole Mullins, the middle linebacker, in with that big body of his, number 6'5", 231, junior. He has a bright future of his own ahead of him, but he brings that physicality in the middle. And it's just tough sledding trying to run against this team with Bothwell and the penetration they get with Maxie and Dinnick inside.
Eighth play of the drive. They've moved from the 20 to the 25. Lewis throws short for Kofer. Intended that time was Hicks, the intended target. Now it's third down, now fourth down.
Good job there, the Hawk defense, keeping everything in front of them. And what a luxury Coach King, Lovelady has. When you can line up with a secondary, just play man and let that defensive line go to work. Juju Lewis going to have to continue to show patience and walk the ball down the field for his offense.
Albertus, rugby-style kick. Caleb Downs trying to position himself to return it. Will not be able to, as it's going to roll dead at the 17-yard line. 38-yard kick. Mill Creek going on offense when we go back.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Clouds are sinking down over the top of the city again on this Saturday night. Mill Creek off to a 7-0 lead as they go on offense for the second time tonight. Wayne, let's take a look at your Breda Pest Management keys to the game when the Hawks have the ball.
Offensively, Mill Creek wants to attack out on the edge with the bubble screen, those outside zones, key blocking by the tight end receivers to have success. And Carrollton in this defense have to rally to the ball. We saw on that last drive with Cam Robinson, the kind of players they have with Downs and Robinson and Woods, they are hard to get down. You got to rally to have success.
They run the screen pass to Brendan Jenkins. It gets blown up right away by Quinn Ackey.
This is what they want to do right here with Hayden Clark. Get things out on the edge. Nice job of Ackey coming up and making that tackle. They want to test you and test you out on the edge. They feel like they have an advantage athletically against your defense. So you're going to have to do that all night long on Mr. Ackey.
Second down and eight. Run the ball to Cam Robinson again, and Ackey is there to make the tackle at the 26-yard line. Let's take a look at the Carrollton defense. Brought to you by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. Farmer, Levy, and Ricks up front. Braden, Bradburn, Smith, and Butler on that second line. Hill, Ackey, Johnson, and Thompson in the secondary.
Going with a hard count, trying to draw the defense off. You can see the defensive front a little off the ball, trying to protect themselves on that zone blocking scheme.
Cam Robinson going to get the first down. Out across the 30 to the 31, picked up five.
Great vision there by Robinson on the cutback here. Nothing to that front side. Good penetration there by Carrollton. But that shiftiness of Robinson, that vision to get in that backside hole to pick up that first down.
Cam Robinson over 1,450 yards rushing this season. Already scored his 19th touchdown here tonight. And Kevin Mitchell gets this carry. He only gets a couple of yards. Carrollton believes they have the football. The officials have not confirmed that yet, but they're running off the field. And the officials have huddled up. I never did see a signal from the officials. Remember, Dave Reynolds, our GPB officials expert, is here in the booth. They've just signaled that it's Carrollton's ball.
Not only no signal, didn't hear a whistle as well. The entire defense of the Trojans reacted here. A little bobble of getting the handoff there by Mitchell. It is a little misty. The ball is wet, and you can see right there the ball is out clearly. Recovered by Jay Farmer, the defensive lineman, number 45, pulling that ball out. He actually pulled it out and recovered the fumble.
This will be a procedure penalty on Carrollton.
First down.
Chris Moore, our referee tonight. There's the rest of the crew working this 7A state championship game.
Carrollton, pre-snap penalties. You just can't have that against a team like Mill Creek. Hard enough to move the ball against them. Got to play efficient, smart football.
Hand off Bryce Hicks. He gets wrapped up. Caleb Downs is the first guy there.
Nice job scraping off of that play. Josh Anglin, the leading tackler, 26. Scraping off of that penetration of Denick to get in there on that play. What a year he has had. Josh Anglin, 6 feet, 212. One of those physical downhill linebackers along with Cole Mullins.
Setting up a screen play to Hicks. Got a blocker down to the 19-yard line. 15-yard pickup, Bryce Hicks.
Nice job of selling this by the line. Patience, patience on screens. Good blocking out on the edge. Only the hustle of Mill Creek stopping that touchdown. Bryce Hicks, what a weapon that young man is. What a season he put on. The best player right now, you can say, on this Carrollton team, period.
Close to 1,600 yards rushing. Gets the ball again. squirms through the hole down to the 16-yard line. And you're absolutely right. He's a junior. This is the second season we've seen Bryce Hicks play. And every time we do, he puts on a show.
Running behind his pads here in the middle, just getting what he can. And those shifty guys like Bryce Hicks, their adjustment to that penetration is to find those little gaps and seams and try to sneak through them. When you see that kind of defensive push, you got to make adjustments.
Carrollton in the express red zone, second down and 7 from the 16. Play action, heavy rush. Lewis stands in there and fires incomplete. And there is a flag out. Contact with the tight end, Jordan White.
Juju Lewis trying to work this ball to White. Nice job of Jamal Anderson as you saw him drop back into coverage and cut off that slant. Tried to throw the ball over him.
Holding. Defense. After this is to the goal from the previous spot. First down.
So this will be a first down for Carrollton.
You can see number one right here, cutting that angle, couldn't directly, tried to loft it over Jamal Anderson, the big tight end. Patterson just a tad early, maybe a hand on the shoulder pad to get that penalty.
First and goal to go. Hicks gets it. Hicks running hard all the way down to the 2-yard line, the 1-yard line. I don't know how he does it. The roster says he's 5'8", 165, but he moves guys twice his size.
Huge offensive weapon running behind his pads here. Leverage, just pushing, getting an assist there by his offensive line. And if you haven't seen this young man play, we have draped two towels over his shoulders for Cotton Commissioner Player of the Game this season.
Hicks, ball out. I think Lewis got on top of it. Hicks took a mammoth shot behind the line of scrimmage, and you saw him do something there that you never see him do, fumble. That's how hard he was hit.
Getting up slow right there is Hicks as well. Big hit here.
The ball was out before he ever got hit.
Never really got the ball. Once again, that Mill Creek D-line with the penetration. This offensive line, especially inside, they're going to have to cut down those splits and get off the ball. They're losing the line of scrimmage for their team at the moment.
Third down and goal from the 5. Toss to Hicks. Got by Anderson and dropped at the 5-yard line. Jamal Anderson had a crack at him back at the 10, but he just does get back to the line of scrimmage, and I'm guessing they're going to shoot for a field goal here.
Great job of beating the block of Jordan White as Anderson. We talked about in the open, one of those guys that a lot of teams, they try to run away from him. They run check systems to get the ball, but now he's playing more out on the edge. Anglin and Mullins are playing more in the middle and already in this first quarter having a big game.
They have several kickers. Freddie Perez will take this one. It's a 22-yard attempt from the right hash. Albertus is the holder. The kick is blocked. Scoop opportunity and score opportunity for Jamal Anderson. They're not going to catch him. 86 yards.
Jaden Patterson, number 13, literally taking the ball off of the kicker's foot here. Watch how fast 13 comes into your screen. And then the 4-star headed to Clemson is headed for a touchdown. Jamal Anderson, not sure his dad ever had that kind of speed, but the big fella at 6'4", 200 pounds, showing you all of why Clemson is smiling for him to arrive.
Ulrich with the PAT, and just as it appeared, Carrollton might score a touchdown, at least a field goal. They get neither, and Mill Creek gets an 86-yard block, punt, block, kick return touchdown, and it's a 14-0 lead for the Hawks.
Disappointed.
Jamal Anderson, what a play, and what a great play by Jaden Patterson. You mentioned it. That's the whole key right there. Patterson with the block on the field goal. And as soon as Anderson, it was designed that way, that I'm going to block it right to you. He was standing there, fielded it like a shortstop on a high hop, and took off running.
That rush in is typically just trying to get his hands. Patterson was able to get his entire body in knocking that ball down. What a big play, big turnaround. Remember, Carrollton had the ball down on the 1 yard line.
Carrollton's got to be a little shell shocked right here. Again, a non-returnable kick off the foot of Ulrich. They'll bring it out to the 20. Let's take a look at the road to the championship for Mill Creek. We saw several of these games here on GPB. They beat Meadow Creek in the first round. And then we saw their 43-7 victory over North Cobb in the second round. And we all thought North Cobb was a semifinal team, and they beat them easily. Westlake in the quarters, and then Milton in the semifinals last week. Beat them easily.
It's just been a great team effort. Each side of the ball has taken its turn of dominating, and right now this defense is something to be reckoned with.
Jump ball goes to Odom. So Carrollton comes right back. Lewis puts it right on the money to Caleb Odom.
Got to work those one-on-one matchups, especially out on the edge to Caleb Odom. Good high ball. Nice job by the big receiver of snatching that away from Trajan Greco. And we talked about this offense. If they're going to have any chance of winning today, those are the kind of plays. When they get those one-on-one matchups, they have to come up with those plays.
Lewis, strong throw on the run. And Childers over the shoulder.
And this is why this young man, Juju Lewis, is so special. A little rollout. Didn't like his first read right there. To Lipscomb, still going through the route tree, finding self Childers down the field. Watch this young man work. And look at the snap on this ball.
How hard is that throw that he just made?
Beautiful snap. Great, great throw. Only 15 years old is Lewis.
Timeout. Mill Creek. It's their first charge coming out of the half.
The strength that it takes for Juju Lewis, much less a freshman, to make that kind of throw on the move is phenomenal. You can see why everybody in the nation has wanted to offer this guy.
Nice job of him just filling the offense. You can see rollout. He wanted to go to Carr Lipscomb underneath. Saw that. The defense took that away from him and then worked down the field to Childers. And as we talked about, he has an assortment of weapons with Lipscomb and Odom. We talk about them. They have all the stars. But Childers, Coffer, and White, the tight end, very productive this season.
And you can see why. I mean, the young man has championship pedigree. He's played football all his life. Has extraordinary skill set. And oftentimes the comparison with Trevor Lawrence, because Joey King's his coach, size-wise, he's not Trevor Lawrence. But cerebrally, his thought process and the way he understands the game is like Trevor Lawrence. Up top, trying to get it to Kofor, touchdown. Carrollton comes right back with a 27-yard touchdown pass. Lewis to Kion Kofor.
Kofor, the young sophomore, working out of the slot. And from the snap, you could see Juju Lewis knew where he wanted to go with that ball, working on the safety, Patterson. Great ball, leading the receiver, keeping the ball high for him, dropping it in the bucket. If you're just checking out this game, never seen Juju Lewis work. He is a special kind of quarterback. And those are the plays, Matt, they're going to have to make. Nice job right there. Nice drops that ball. Tough catch there by the young wide receiver Cofer as well, over the shoulder, on his outside shoulder, bringing that ball in.
Extraordinary skill set. Hard to describe it. Let's check in with Nikki.
Matt Wayne, you know, when we've been talking to Coach Joey King about Juju, he kept using the term maturation process and talking about him. And he said, look, it's been fun to see this kid. And we say kid because he's 15. He's got braces. His dad still drops him off at school, but take on a leadership role. He said he just holds his guys accountable. And then I asked him, I said, okay, but how did the seniors look at him? And they say, look, when you play like he plays and you play at that high level and you show up to work every day, he goes, they respect him and they've really taken him under his wing.
Yeah, Coach King said he's been encouraging Juju to smile in his pictures, but Juju is reticent because he still has braces. His coach, wait until I get rid of my braces. Doesn't want to smile in his pictures.
So he's making us smile with the way that he can throw the ball around the football field.
Kick coming down at the 4-yard line. Big return. This is going to go. Are you kidding me? Mikael Wood, center stage.
Carrollton kickoff team doing the right thing, not kicking the ball to Caleb Downs, but up on the other side of the field, Mikael Wood, the Eastern Michigan commit, and watch, the kicker right here has no chance against that kind of athlete in the middle of the field. And then it's just about the speed, his teammate Greco hustling down the field to get a little interference to make sure no one runs him down.
Ulrich PAT. That's why I used the word lightning when I described Mikael Wood.
Great job. Untouched right here. Good blocking. And when you put that kind of athlete in the middle of the field against a kicker, you could see one move, one cut, and now we're just going to outrun you. The blocking, great job getting beating that first wave. And now it's just the foot race. What a special player. Break the tape, young man. Break the tape.
Phenomenal start to the 7A championship game. Here in the first quarter, we've already had 3 touchdowns of 66-plus yards. 3 scores in 30 seconds. It's 21-7.
We came to see the stars, and they are shining bright in this 7A championship.
Another non-returnable kick from Ulrich. You can see one of the reasons why he was named GPB Sports All-State Kicker. Rarely does the kick land in territory where you can return it. Also, phenomenal field goal kicker with a long of 56 this season in Mercedes-Benz Stadium.
6'6 is Ulrich. And as you said, Matt, it's not even close to looking like it's returnable when he gets that leg underneath it. Great job and great season he's had.
Carrollton back on offense again. Wings it out here to Odom. Greco was on the coverage. They were trying to set up a screen. Goes incomplete.
Having success on that last drive, getting the ball down the field. But this secondary of Mill Creek, they're not going to back away. You're going to have to continue to throw the ball and beat them. They're going to stay in man. They believe they have the talent and the corners that can do the job. And Trajan Greco, only a junior, his recruiting is going to pick up into next year. We've seen him do an excellent job this season.
Up top and caught over the shoulder. This is a foot race. Bryce Hicks, no one will catch him. 80 yards. What the heck?
Bryce Hicks running a wheel route once again. Langston Agee trying to get in the foot race. We told you this young man at one point, he was the leading receiver and rusher. Beautiful ball by the quarterback. Can't get a better throw. And then when the foot race starts, you can always count on Mr. Hicks to win it.
Unbelievable. PAT is good. 21-14.
This is just all about Bryce Hicks, his ability out on the edge. Came into this game with close to 60 receptions. Here just outrunning Langston Agee, who's more like a safety and just never could get back into that play, as you can see. And then turning on the Jets is Bryce Hicks. When Coach King told us that this young man was the best player on his football team, I think both of us was kind of like, hold on, all these other players with all the stars, and he has proven his head coach to be correct.
Four scores in 44 seconds. And Lewis already has 176 yards of offense in the game. Non-returnable. That's the only way you can ensure that there will not be a kickoff return touchdown is to kick it into the end zone.
And you could see Freddie Perez there put a little extra into his kick. He was making sure that ball was going into the end zone.
You see the special teams touchdowns already for Mill Creek in this game. An 86-yard block field goal return touchdown by Jamal Anderson and a 96-yard kick return touchdown by Mikel Wood. Oh, yeah, and we had a 66-yard touchdown run by Cam Robinson just by the regular offense. And they're going for a home run. Got a man wide open. That's going to be a long touchdown for Justin Content. 80 yards. Does anybody play defense?
Busted coverage on the back end here by the Trojans. Justice Content wide open. No one is in the picture here. Just leaking out. Cam Robinson on that swing route drew the safety up. And nobody went with Justin Content out on the edge. Nice job by Hayden Clark of finding him. And another big play for Mill Creek.
And Ulrich scrapes the upright as he puts the PAT through. 28-14. You might think they forgot about Justin Content. He had only one catch on the entire season, so he might have gotten ignored on that play. Well, next time they won't. 80 yards on that touchdown pass play.
Totally busted on that coverage right there. And you're right. No stats really to say who is going to deliver on that play. But you could see with that swing route with Cam Robinson, he really pulled the safety up. And you had two guys taking him, and then you have Content down the sideline. Just a great job offensively.
We've had five scores in 55 seconds. That's more than you get in a basketball game. Let's check in with Nikki.
Matt Wayne, yeah, Joey's visibly frustrated after those plays. They're not little plays. They're big, explosive plays. They're talking about needing that coverage there. And he's saying, man, we can't keep giving up these touchdowns. This is ridiculous.
28-14. I've never seen anything quite like that. What we've seen here in the opening quarter of this 7A state championship game. And Ulrich, again, that one goes 73 yards.
The adrenaline is high on this field.
He only has an offer from Stetson, but I'm pretty sure that some Power 5 coaches watching this game tonight will be interested in his talent.
Well, at least the coaches that live in this stadium might call him. We are in Georgia State Stadium. Might get a call from their recruiters here as well.
Three scores Mill Creek, two for Carrollton, five total in 55 seconds. And Hicks on the run. Maybe we'll settle down for a minute and play just normal football.
Only a two-yard gain right there by Bryce Hicks, but good job of him avoiding that pressure. He's going to have to adjust to having D linemen on his side of the ball. Right now, they are taking advantage of this offensive line of Carrollton. They got to help their running back out and at least cut down the penetration.
Clock down to 7 in the quarter. They got the playoff before the end of the quarter. Lewis scrambling and throwing off his back foot. Intercepted! Content, who just had the 80-yard reception, just picked off the pass. Wow. Floated it out there. That was easy pickings for Justin Content. And Mill Creek's going to have the ball at the 12-yard line. We start the second quarter. They've already scored 28, and they lead by two touchdowns.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna. Together all the way. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households, striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
Respect. It's more than a word. In the U.S. Army, respect is earned every day. Now, in addition to earning respect, you may qualify for more. Information at goarmy.com/bonus or 800-USA-ARMY. Paid for by the U.S. Army.
Start of the second quarter, Mill Creek on top of Carrollton, 28-14. Buckle up, Georgia. And if you weren't buckled up watching that first quarter sitting on the sofa, you probably just flew off the sofa right into the corner of the room. It was such a crazy whirlwind of a first 12 minutes, unlike anything I've seen in any game, much less a game with the championship on the line. And Mill Creek starts at the 12-yard line after the interception by Content. Matt Stewart, Wayne Gandy, Nikki Noto-Palmer, thanks for joining us here for the 7A title game. Pass thrown, touchdown! Mikael Wood, no, he dropped it.
RPO game here with Hayden Clark, great find. Good route here by Mikael Wood, just couldn't come up with the catch. Nice read here by Clark, it's there for him. Good ball, and just couldn't grab it right there is Wood.
He was trying to keep it off the ground. Second down and 10.
You can see the frustration. He knew he had a touchdown right there. A lot of space up top. Brendan Jenkins for Hayden Clark.
Cam Robinson right through the defense. Did he break the plane? They're going to rule him down at the 1-yard line.
You mentioned this before, Matt, with the Hawks and Cam Robinson, zone read to the outside. Great job running between the tackles behind his pass is Robinson.
First and goal to go. Clark runs up to the line of scrimmage, going to try to sneak it in. He did not get in that time.
Hayden Clark bobbled.
Even though his body's laying across the goal line right now, they stopped his forward motion, they ruled.
Bobbled that snap going under center. You can see Coach Lovelady telling him to huddle up. And I think we're going to finally maybe get that special package he told me he was going to deliver, that jumbo package. Seven offensive linemen, three tight ends are in the game for Mill Creek.
And going Wildcat with Caleb Downs. Downs going to take the snap, and Downs did not get in. So the Trojans stop.
Offense.
Well, they'll back him up and make it second down and goal from outside the five.
Good blocking initially. Good penetration out there on the edge by Miles Butler, number four. Without that penetration by him, it would have been a walk-in touchdown for Caleb Downs. The jumbo package still out on the field.
Second down and goal. Caleb Downs going to the near side, clears that edge, tries to reach for the pylon, and he gets in for the touchdown. Body never got in the end zone, but like you've seen so many great college and pro players do, extended that ball out to make it clip the pylon for the score.
Zone blocking out on the edge. Good job there by Nick Maxey. Great job by Caleb Downs, sticking the ball out. And you can see, Matt, the instincts by that young man, putting that ball, knocking the pylon down.
Ulrich, PAT, and it's 35-14.
Good job here. Special talent out in space, Caleb Downs.
Watch the foot.
And it's bang, bang, that foot, that left foot as he went to reach for the pylon. Let's see again.
Yeah, where's the ball in his foot now? He's not there yet. Yeah, I think, I think he's probably out of bounds before, right there, right before the ball gets to the pylon. As you know, there is no replay in Georgia high school football, so the call will stand as it was made on the field.
What confidence Coach Lovelady showed in that package. That jumbo package was specifically for 2-3 yards, and in that situation, being able to get a 6-yard touchdown.
Hey,
nice job.
Let's get a stop again.
And Caleb Downs once again showing you what special talent he is.
Five different players have scored touchdowns for Mill Creek, and we still have not played a complete 14 minutes yet in this game. See if Ulrich's leg gets tired. Nope. Non-returnable. They'll bring it out to the 20. Let's check in with Nikki.
You guys, when we talked to Coach Lovelady this week, we were asking about Caleb Downs, and he said, look, this is a special week. We're playing in the championship game. For Caleb, he actually graduates early, but here's the thing. The touchdown club wanted to decorate the field house. There were some mamas that wanted to put up posters and stuff like that and streamers. Well, Caleb saw it, and he goes, Coach, what's going on over here? He said, they're acting like we've won something. We hadn't won anything yet. He said, Caleb is just super laser focused. He comes across as a coach, and he finally told him, hey, bud, it's okay. We're going to enjoy this too.
Yeah, that was the message from Josh Lovelady to Caleb and the rest of the team. We're here for business, but enjoy the week. Long pass. It's caught. That's another long touchdown. Caleb Odom going to take it 80 yards.
State of Georgia, welcome to the Juju Lewis Show. Young freshman, number 10. We've seen them go with this little short rollout going through his route tree. You could see him, and then decided to go back to his big target. One-on-one matchup once again, getting Caleb Odom on Trajan Greco out in space. Only the speed of Downs to even have a chance of bringing him down short of the goal line. Big playability, the four-star Caleb Odom.
35-21. We've had 56 points scored in this game in less than 14 minutes.
Little rollout to the right. Go back to that backside one-on-one matchup. Falling down is the corner Greco. And then it just becomes a foot race for the big 6'6 target.
And how about the strength of Caleb Odom on that stiff arm to floor Caleb Downs?
Coming from a long distance, but that young man, big numbers this season for his team. 6'6", you see the length. He's just a big target, and that's that where he might have to move in, maybe play a little more tight end. Yeah, great basketball player as well is Odom.
Yep. Four-star, rated as high as the number 6 tight end in the country, although he plays wide receiver for Carrollton. 23 offers, including Tennessee, Ole Miss, and Vandy. Kick, taking it to one. Mikael Wood already has one touchdown return tonight. He gets stopped at the 20-yard line this time. Watch how powerful Caleb Odom is at the end of an 80-yard run.
That long arm, you could see the size difference. And Caleb Downs is 6'2", around 200 pounds. But you can see that wingspan and why he's so highly rated. Only a junior is Odom. Great find by the quarterback. And you mentioned it, Matt. I don't know if we're going to see regular offense at any point tonight.
Cam Robinson gets stopped for a short 12-yard gain. Anything less than an 80-yard touchdown is disappointing.
Nice job over there, that right tackle side, that right guard, Jeremiah Sheen, Jax Murphy.
Yeah, I mean, they're doing this with a right tackle in Jax Murphy, who's 210.
It is staying on blocks, doing a good job. Aiden Banfield, their left guard, is their bell cow.
Banfield, 5 offers, including Georgia Tech and Vanderbilt. Caleb Downs gets the carry. Caleb Downs up to the 50-yard line.
And we've seen games where Caleb Downs gets in at running back, and you forget all about how great of a safety he is. Zone read to the outside. Good blocking there by the offensive line. Cooper Bothwell over there at the left guard, left tackle. And this young man is just scary out in the open field. Touchdown saving tackle there by Michael Braden, number 8.
The word was that Ryan Day, the Ohio State coach, was going to be here in attendance tonight to watch Caleb Downs. Clark going to take off and run. And the flag is down at the 47-yard line. Of course, Caleb Downs been committed to Alabama since the summer, but did take a visit to Ohio State for the Michigan game. With National Signing Day coming up, no doubt Ryan Day hoping to change his mind.
10-yard penalty from the spot of foul. Replay, first down.
I'm quite sure it might be a limo SUV out there with Bama on it. They're just going to take him from the locker room
to Tuscaloosa.
And take him to Tuscaloosa. Won't be any more of that Travis Hunter stuff going on if you let Nick Saban talk to you about it. Holding there on the left tackle, Abraham Blanco, who was in for Jack Murphy on that play.
Well, you look at him, Caleb Downs over on the sideline. You look at the body, the physique. Ben Reeves, the head coach of Milton, said the first time I saw him, I was thinking, oh my gosh, there's an NFL safety over there playing for the Hawks. Cam Robinson on the carry. He gets stuffed by Jacob Levy.
Nice job of Levy working down the line of scrimmage. What a player that young man has become. Only a sophomore. Watch 51 work down the line, beating the left guard, Jeremiah Sheen. And he just has that leverage. He's 5'10", one of the top wrestlers in the country at his weight size.
Yeah, he's ranked number two in the country in his weight size, which I'm guessing is heavyweight at 221. He power cleans 320.
And you can see the D-line off the ball, trying not to get caught in that zone blocking scheme.
Hayden Clark going to take off running. Wide open field. And Hayden Clark finally brought down at the 18-yard line. Hayden's like, man, everybody else is getting a long run. I might as well get one, too.
Everybody's mentioning, getting mentioned except me, the efficient senior. Great job beating the pressure, showing you the speed, trying to set up his block on the outside with Wood to get some extra yardage.
That's a 50-yard run by Hayden Clark. He's been offered by Washburn and Reinhardt, a couple of NAIA schools. Cam Robinson gets stopped in the hole.
Good job there by Miles Butler, number four. Just not going to let that play bounce to the outside. Montrez Smith coming up with the tackle. Haven't been able to call his name, but he's had a great season for his team as well.
Looks like the misty rain has thickened up a little bit. Looks like it's a little bit heavier. Still not really problematic, but you can see it's kind of a misty fog that's coming down across the stadium now. Clark on a play action, all kinds of time in the pocket. Jump ball back of the end zone, incomplete. Kelvin Hill, who's their top cornerback, shutting down Brendan Jenkins there.
And Hayden Clark wants this ball back right now. He had Mikael Wood underneath for a touchdown, number four. You saw him right there late in your screen. Decided he was going to go to Jenkins. And good job there by Calvin Hill.
Yeah, that's the guy that Joey King calls their dog back there. And always chirping at the college coaches to give this guy an offer. Georgia Southern finally did. The Eagles made him their first offer. Pass complete out there to Caleb Downs. And again, he tries to lunge for the pylon. It worked the first time, not this time.
Somebody's trying to throw themselves a birthday party, and his name is Caleb Downs. Great route. Motion out of the backfield. Get the ball. So dangerous out in space. Just hard for anyone to come over and make that play. Reaching out, trying to knock it down again for his second touchdown.
Extraordinary athlete who started as a ninth grader for Mill Creek. Josh Lovelady says back then the jersey was just like draped on him. He had just hung on him. He has filled it out, no doubt about it. He's in there to play the Wildcat. Direct snap to him. Hops over for the touchdown. Mill Creek has scored 41 points in the first 18 minutes of this game.
Just tough to defend this play here when you have a guy like Caleb Downs and Cam Robinson in the backfield right there. Decide to hit you with the Bo Jackson and go into the end zone. The spring off the ground. Did you see how high that young man got?
I know you're an Auburn. I know you're an Auburn grad, but you know, he's Alabama. You can't use the Bo Jackson when you're talking about him. The Crimson Tide fans are going to get fired up about that.
Media timeout.
Yeah, he looks like Bo Jackson. It's 42-21.
The 2022 GHSA Football Championships are presented by this supporter of the GHSA, the Georgia Farm Bureau. Always the home team.
Record-breaking winds and rainfall combined the area last night as an unexpected.
Hey, Danny. Y'all make it through the storm last night? Don't worry, I'm on my way. Let's go to work, Lucky.
You got a branch right shot.
It's good to be lucky. It's better to have Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance.
We are a farm bureau. Are you an enthusiastic sports fan? Want to have fun and get in on the action?
Heck yes, that'd be awesome.
Have great attention to detail? Want to stay active?
Definitely.
Want to give back to the student athletes in your community?
Obviously, yes.
Then you'd make an excellent high school sports official. We need more officials in Georgia, because with no high school officials, there are no high school sports. Sign up today at highschoolofficials.com.
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
Mill Creek leading Carrollton 42-21. That's not the fourth quarter. It's the second quarter. And Caleb Downs putting on a show here as the rest of his Mill Creek teammates are too. Five different players have scored in the opening 18 minutes of this game. And Carrollton, of course, they've been able to be a quick strike offense too, but they're three scores behind. It's hard to believe Carrollton has scored 21 points in the opening 18 minutes of the game, and they trail by 21 points.
Both sides of the ball just being electric here tonight. Big-time players. The star players for both teams are shining. It's just right now Mill Creek is in a zone offensively that Carrollton, up to this point, has not been able to match.
Kickoff from Ulrich again will be non-returnable. And Carrollton will bring it out to the 20-yard line. Of course, also throw in the fact that there have been two special teams touchdowns for Mill Creek in this game as well. Jamal Anderson, the blocked field goal, he returned for a touchdown. And Mikel Wood with the 96-yard kick return touchdown.
But this offense of the Trojans definitely can take the field with a lot of confidence that they have the ability to score against this defense. They're winning those one-on-one matchups that they came in to win, and they just got to keep chopping wood and hope they get a couple of breaks.
Yeah, I don't think that Joey King has any concern that they can't score. His concern is, can they stop Mill Creek from scoring? We know Carrollton can score, but can they stop Mill Creek? They haven't really proven that tonight. And it's hard to believe. Think back. This game started with a three and out.
It's been electrifying plays on both sides of the ball. Bryce Hicks is shying for his team. Got to keep him involved. But Juju Lewis working those one-on-one combinations. He's finding the weakness and he's attacking it.
Lewis, heavy rush, gets it out of there hot. Had to get it out of there in a hurry because pressure was coming. Kofer was the intended target. He's already got a 27-yard touchdown catch in this game.
And this pressure here by Langston Agee is really what saves this touchdown. Kofer had the route in the middle of the field, playing man. There's no one in the back end to stop him if he catches that ball. But the pressure right there by Agee off the corner made Lewis have to throw the ball short.
I mean, every one of the Mill Creek defenders is within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage. Up top they go, and another jump ball to Caleb Oldhams, and this time gets broken up by Trajan Greco.
And this is the confidence that Coach Lovelady has in his defense. They've been beat several times in these one-on-one matchups. This time losing Odom is Greco. Just not enough real estate to land to pick up that first down.
Looked like we just had a hockey line shift on defense for Mill Creek. They had like 6 guys come on the field. 6 guys go off. But again, everybody, I mean, look how crowded they are here. This is fourth down, and they're going to fake it and go for it. And they're not going to get it. Albertus did not get it. They went for the fake punt right there on 4th and 3 at their own 27 and only got 1 yard.
Good blocking. Initially, it looked like good job right there by Content of getting off the block. When you watch that play early on, If he doesn't get off of that block, the punter is going to pick up that first down. But his ability to get off of that block and at least slow him down until his other teammates got there. And what a big gamble there by Joey King. But the way that Mill Creek is playing, you kind of understand each and every possession now, he's in desperation mode.
12th 40-point game of the season for Mill Creek already. Clark gonna step up and run it. And he picks up close to 9 on the play.
Good job by the offensive line. Plenty of time, just nowhere to go with this ball. Good defense here by the Trojans on the back end. You can see the protection here. Just nowhere to go with the ball, doing the smart thing. Like to see him put the ball away right there, not run with it so loosely if you're Coach Lovelady. But nice job, great decision maker by the Clark, the senior.
Second down and 1. Big hole, Cam Robinson down inside the 5. Michael Braden made the touchdown saving tackle, at least for the moment.
Cam Robinson so electric here, zone blocking. Had on a hat up front by the offensive line. As you can see, when you have that kind of speed and explosiveness of Robinson, you hit the line, nobody's there. This line up front, we talked about it, it's been special for this team this season.
Hawks in the express red zone. Clark sprints out to the top. Direct snap. We're going to run it back to Caleb Downs. Philly special, maybe? Nope. He's going to run it himself to the pylon. Touchdown. His talent level is so incredible. He's playing against a great team, but he looks like he's playing a level above everybody else.
And right here on this reverse, when he got over here, he knew it initially he was not going to be able to beat Miles Butler to the corner. So he stutter stepped, made Miles Butler stop his feet, knowing he could outrun him to the end zone. Watch right here. He gets his reverse. He knows initially he can't get there. He slows up, makes Miles Butler have to reset his feet, knowing the kind of speed he has.
Yep.
Yeah. I feel you, young man. Yeah, three. That's three. Three touchdowns for him tonight.
Unbelievable. Caleb Downs' world, we're just all living in it. 49-21.
Just a true talent. Sometimes we get the joy and the pleasure of watching guys that you just know really on that path to Sunday. They just have that it about them that you just hope nothing comes up in the next 2 or 3 years that to disrupt it. But the talent set is there with that young man.
His dad played in the NFL. His uncle played in the National Football League. His older brother is headed to the National Football League sooner than later. Kick is coming down and going to go into the end zone. Of course, his dad is the running backs coach at East Tennessee State, Gary, and played at NC State, played in the NFL. His uncle is Dre Bly, one of the great corners in NFL history, secondary coach at North Carolina. His brother Josh, all ACC wide receiver at North Carolina.
Two times. Make sure you give him his credit.
Two times.
And I thought I saw him leaving. Is that correct, Josh?
Is he?
Is leaving early, I think, and going for the NFL.
He is, and he certainly has the talent to do it. They're setting up the screen here for Bryce Hicks, and Hicks keeps his balance. And Hicks all the way up to the 45-yard line.
Great job once again running the screen. Bryce Hicks out in the open field. Just a special back. Nice job by the line. Patience. Bodies out front securing blocks. And then it just becomes the Bryce Hicks show. As we talked about so much with him, only listed at 165, but a lot of times it's taking two or three bodies to bring him down.
Hit in the backfield, and that's Cole Mullins. Name to remember, gets the TFL on Bryce Hicks.
Cole Mullins coming downhill. The penetration by this defensive line is what really has just taken the run game away from Carrollton. Cole Mullins definitely has the talent and the size to be a special player. Only a junior, listed at 6'4", 231.
He's been offered by Wake Forest, Duke, and Vanderbilt so far. He's also a star baseball player. Lewis being chased, delivers downfield. Great effort by Bryce Hicks. And they're going to confer to see whether he caught it or not. He caught it. Did he keep his feet down? That's the question. They're going to say he did. Wow, what a catch. Body control by Bryce Hicks. Another reason why I think he's one of the most underrated players in the state.
Big pressure. Nice throw by Lewis. Toes. From our angle, maybe he was still up in the air. Great job of concentrating. Let's see.
I think he's got some grass
on
the tip.
Like maybe hit a couple of those pebbles with his toe right there.
Pass thrown and nearly intercepted. Takari Lipson running a post pattern there. And Content, who already has a pick, already has an 80-yard touchdown reception in this game, nearly had himself another turnover.
Good route there by Lipson, just missing him. Shuchu Lewis, high ball right there. Good route in front of Content. He had that post. Just got to bring that ball down if you're Juju Lewis.
Throw back and batted down by Cole Mullins. That's the third pass that this Mill Creek defense has been able to bat out of the air tonight.
Jamal Anderson, Nick Dennett early in the game, knocking the ball down. This time, Mullins off the edge. He senses. Good job reading the quarterback eyes. You can see him as Lewis opened up his shoulders to throw the ball, get his hands up. Nice job trying to throw over Cole Mullins. As I said, he's listed at 6'4". Big, tall linebacker.
Third and 10. Downfield, and it's caught at the 25-yard line. That's the tight end making the grab. He's a solid tight end, Jordan White. He's got over 300 yards receiving this season.
Beautiful route here by White. Little double move and great hands there by that young man, 6'2". Watch this move. Right there, set up AG.
Wow, one-handed. Snagged a bullet out of the air. First and 10 from the 22. Lewis throwing on the run, and touchdown, Takari Lipscomb.
This high-powered offense, they're doing everything they need to do to give their team a chance. Lipscomb, the three-star headed to Arkansas State. Little rollout. We've seen Lewis throw the ball on the dime, on the move, foot down, ball secure. Great job working against Justin Content to bring that ball in.
49-27, make it 49-28. Typically, I would say that's a SportsCenter top 10 nominee play, but if we used all the highlights you'd need, like SportsCenter top 25 nominee, I mean, it has been unbelievable the number of spectacular plays. Just the placement of that pass and the body control to make sure you get your foot down as you're diving backwards out of the end zone.
Just a go route right there on Content, giving up a couple of inches as Lipscomb. A good job using that arm to keep Content, give his quarterback some room.
Committed.
But what a young freshman throwing the ball on the run like that, moving. It's hard enough to throw as a quarterback set in the pocket, but to drop that ball in, wow.
has 340 yards passing in this game already. 340 in the first half. And he's ninth grader, 15 years old. Silly, stupid talent. I mean, it's just unbelievable.
What a big future that young man. We talked about Caleb Downs being the best player in the state. That might be a picture of a young man that also pulls and holds that trophy up. And I'm not talking about senior year. It could be the way he throws the ball. It could be sophomore, junior year.
22 offers, including Georgia, Alabama, and Florida. You could really say if everybody just offered, which they would want to do, some people don't even try. They're like, oh, well, we're not getting that guy. Everybody in the country would want him. The offer would be over 100. But what's the point, right? There's only going to be a handful. I mean, when you talk about it, the best of the best going to have a shot at this kid. Cam Robinson dragged down. Ball came out, but down with contact with the ground. Ball out with that. It's not a fumble.
Great hustle there by Montrez Smith. Good run by Robinson. He's down right there. Took a big hit getting slammed here at the end. Little screen swing pass out on the edge. Jax Murphy is out in front of him.
Yeah,
and if Montrez Smith doesn't come in here and knock him down, that could be a touchdown. But that ball is out.
Yeah.
That is a fumble right there. You can see the ball is out. There is no review.
And Joey King is pointing to the big screen here, and you can hear the fans react. They see it, but there's nothing the officials can do to change the call.
Maybe touchdown saving tackle right there by Montrez Smith. Good play design on that screen pass to Cam Robinson. Just took a big hit there. Not the biggest of backs.
But he plays big.
But he plays huge.
9 carries, 116, and a touchdown in the first half. Crowd still upset about the call, but it's going to be Mill Creek's ball. Second down and one at the 29. A timeout has been called. Mill Creek has two remaining. Joey King still trying to make his argument. That'll get him nowhere. Second down and one. Caleb Downs in motion. Up top. Man open, streaking there. Caught under deflection by Brendan Jenkins.
Brendan Jenkins one-on-one out in the open field. Jaden Thompson in tight coverage. Good job here by Hayden Clark with the little pump fake to freeze the D-end. Nice job, Akey, right there. Excuse me, 21, getting a hand on the ball. Great concentration by Brendan Jenkins. We talked about one of those guys with his size and talent. This could just be the beginning of what he can do as he moves on. The son of Michael Jenkins, former Atlanta Falcon.
First and 10 after the catch by Jenkins. It went for 46 yards, trying to run a wheel route there to Cam Robinson. And it's going to be second down. But Jenkins, 12 offers, Mercer, Lehigh, Middle Tennessee. Not Power 5 schools by any means, but I agree with you. He's got a skill set. At 6'2", 196 senior, and he's really smart. He knows the position. I think he plays it well. It'll be interesting to see what happens with him as National Signing Day approaches.
Texas dad earlier, he's in the building looking at his son. He's wearing number 12, which was his dad's number.
Second down and 10 and a timeout called by Mill Creek. Wayne, Mill Creek's trying to hang 56 on the board in the first half. And the funny thing about it, even if they do get the touchdown here, go up 56-28, I've unfortunately had some games where a team scored 56 in the first half. They were all massacres. This is not a massacre. This is a game.
This is keep your foot on the gas if you're Mill Creek, because your defense is struggling to stop Carrollton and their big play ability. And I think that's why Coach Lovelady is not taking this drive and just trying to get to the halftime. He's trying to put more points on the board.
Yeah, again, the story, I mean, I have no doubt from what we've seen here in the first half, Carrollton can get to 56 tonight. But if they get to 56, Mill Creek might be over 100.
This is a great game.
You keep wondering when the game's going to settle into more of a traditional game, but it's just been big shot after big shot after big shot. And they're all connecting. Second down and 10 from the 25. Hayden Clark surveys the field, going for the shot in the end zone. It's intercepted. That's a big pick right there for the Carrollton Trojans as Jaden Thompson stops the Mill Creek rally. They will not put 56 on the board in the first half.
Great job of protection here. Hayden Clark just being a little greedy, as you can see. There's four black jerseys fading off. Nice job going to get that interception. Jaden Thompson going up high to bring that ball down, trying to find Brandon Jenkins in the back of the end zone.
Up until last week's game, he had thrown only one interception the entire season. So first and 10 Trojans. Let's see if they take another shot. I think you do. I mean, you've stolen a possession. You got to try to take a shot here and get a touchdown.
They're in five wide. They're spread it out. They're going to let their young freshman go to work.
And a timeout called. This is an official timeout, not called by a team.
So he was pointing at the far end zone. Maybe the
bands are too close. Is that what it is? So down on the far end of the end zone, where Juju Lewis would be looking to the play clock, they were obscuring the clock. He couldn't see it. So they're making the band kind of squish up against the wall and get out in front of get out from being in front of the clock.
The young freshman just sees everything. He's out there. He's directing traffic. Get the van out the way. I'm about to go down and score.
Stupid numbers in the first half. Passes on a drag right across the middle. Odom up to the 40-yard line. They have all three timeouts remaining. Don't use one yet.
Great job there. Drag route. Finding him on that back end was Lewis, just outrunning Josh Anglin.
Not sure why they didn't use a timeout there. Now they do. They wasted a lot of time.
Officials timeout for injury.
Well, they didn't even call a timeout. It's an official timeout. Nick Maxey, number 88, is down on his back. Looks like a
Please
cramp.
Please reset the game clock to 15 seconds.
But why would you not call the timeout after getting the completion up to the 41? There was still, roughly 18, 19 seconds. You lost 3 or 4 seconds, and you got three timeouts. They don't do you any good sitting there. Unless, of course, you just want to go up-tempo and try to score, get Mill Creek in transition on defense, get them, snap the ball when they're not set, that kind of thing, which may be the intent and purpose for doing exactly what I was wondering why they hadn't done what they did.
I think Coach King right there kind of upset, maybe thinking that Maxey just fell to the ground to break that momentum.
Clock will start on the whistle. There it goes. Lewis throwing on the run, complete to his tight end, who's going to run down the sideline. Did he get out of bounds? They're going to rule him out of bounds at the 35, the 30, Let's see where they end up spotting that thing.
We'll roll out. We've seen this play here. This young man.
Well, they're going to say he stepped out at the 46.
Great at throwing the ball on the run, finding his back, big tight end. 6 seconds. You have to think they're going to attack vertically and go for the end zone here.
Thought they could have been a little bit more judicious with their timeouts. Timeout called by Mill Creek.
Timeout. Mill Creek. That's their third and final timeout of the half.
They took over with 30 seconds and took over from the 20. I thought they could have used, now they may score on the next play, make me sound stupid, but I thought they could have used the clock a little bit better, used the timeouts a little bit better.
Definitely trying to catch Mill Creek off guard, keeping that up tempo. Right here, only 6 seconds. They did put 3 seconds back on the clock. If you're Mill Creek, you've got to make Carrollton catch this ball in front of you. Whatever you do at this moment, no one can get behind you on that back end. And I think that's why Coach Lovelady called that timeout, to make sure his defense keeps all black jerseys in front of him. And you can see Jamal Anderson getting back. You always like to put that tall body in the back end to try to knock the ball down if it becomes one of those 50-50 balls in the end zone.
Yep, playing the deep center field, and now Caleb Downs is back there with him. Lewis scrambling off to his left, going to throw short, and that's going to be the end of the half. Bounces off the hands of Jamon Evans. And the half ends with Mill Creek leading Carrollton 49-28.
Pressure by the D-line, just never letting Juju set up to launch that ball to the end zone. But what an exciting half of football. We talked so much about Mill Creek, but this Carrollton offense hung 28 up in the first half. Very successful. It's just been a different kind of night for Mill Creek.
All right, let's check in with Nikki Noto.
Coach, you scored 49 points in the first half alone. How's your team found success on the offensive side of the ball?
Well, really, it's about the defense and special teams, you know, making some picks, special teams, some kickoff returns. I think it's everybody, you know, is contributing to the score.
Absolutely. Let's talk about the defense in particular. How do you neutralize that Trojan offense? We just saw it happen right there in this last series.
I tell you what, they got some great balls. I mean, that's what I told my kids is, hey, they're throwing some great balls, great catches. Huh? And that's when you're playing the state championships, that's what it is. But, heck, I don't know. Are we at a track meet or are we at a football game? 49-28, holy cow.
It sure seems that way. You're only up. I say only because the score really isn't indicative of how tight this game is. What's the message to your team to hang in there?
Keep on doing what we do. Worry about Mill Creek, all right? Make them hit those balls that they've been hitting and see if we can just, you know, get two quarters in.
All right, good luck in the second half, Coach. Hannah, we've got a ball game over here at Center Park Stadium for the 7A state championship.
We sure do, Nikki. Coach Lovelady's not wrong. It does look like a track meet. Great reporting in the first half. All right, everybody, stick with us. Coming up on the region's halftime show, we'll break down what's happened on our GHSA championship coverage. Check in with John at Center Park Stadium with some special guests. Name our play of the first half if we can pick one. Much more. It's all right here next on GPB.
Jackson EMC and 31 other participating Georgia Electric membership cooperatives congratulate Mill Creek High School on winning the GHSA Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. This award honors schools that exhibit exemplary sportsmanship during competitive events.
We feel like this is this kind of shows the character of our kids. It shows really what our coaches try to instill in them and our teachers as well, as far as how to handle themselves both in wins and losses. And we're proud that this was something that was recognized by our peers throughout the county and the state.
So it just shows how much respect we have to put on the field, showing good sportsmanship.
and like just looking out for the younger kids, because one day the younger kids are going to be in our spots, and we want them to put on a great brand for ourselves.
Introduced in 2006, this award reinforces the GHSA's philosophy that everyone associated with high school activities, from athletes to spectators, should adhere to the fundamental values it represents.
Jackson EMC is proud to present the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award at Mill Creek High School in Gwinnett County. At Jackson EMC, we live in the communities we serve. So as a Mill Creek parent, I firsthand see why Mill Creek deserves this award. Our student athletes, coaches, fans, and teachers exhibit the values of accountability, integrity, and respect every day.
Georgia's EMCs and the 32 participating membership cooperatives are proud to sponsor the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. Congratulations to the Mill Creek Hawks community.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna. Together all the way. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's affecting your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, just really hadn't thought about it.
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Fridays in Georgia Halftime Show presented by Regions. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. I'm Hannah Gooden. We're live from the GPB Sports Studios in Atlanta. It's halftime of the GHSA 7A Championship game between Carrollton and Mill Creek. We have crowned 10 state champions so far this week. Just one more to go. Let's take a look back at what happened on Georgia's EMC scoreboard. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity. So here's the game we're in right now. Hawks are up 49-28. This is the team's first ever meeting. Carrollton's first time back in the championship game since 2013. Their last title was 1998, and Mill Creek playing for their first ever state title in its 19-year history. So earlier today, it was the odds classifications. 3A Sandy Creek beat Cedar Grove 21-17 to get their first title since 2012. And then it was the 5A matchup where Ware County beat Warner Robins 38-13 for the Gators' first championship in their 64-year history, taking down the two-time defending champs. So day one was on Thursday, and we got things started off with the girls' flag football championships in D1. Southeast Bullock beat Harris County 13-0 to get their second state championship in a row and go 39-0 in program history. Then in D2, Lithia Springs beat Central Carroll 14-0 to go 18-0 on the year. And finally, for girls flag football in D3, Blessed Trinity beat Milton 19-13 in a crazy double overtime game. Finally, it was the boys' turn for tackle football. First, Bowden beat Sly County in single A Division 2. They won it 39-31 to get their first win in 30 years. Then in single A Division 1, PAC beat Swainsboro 52-34 for the Wolverines' second championship in 3 years. Yesterday, it was the evens turn. In double A, Thompson beat Fitzgerald 32-27, taking down the defending 2A champs to earn their first title since 2002. In quad A, Benedictine beat Cedartown 14-13 in a last-second goal line stand to win back-to-back state titles and fourth in program history. And finally, in 6A, Langston Hughes beat Gainesville 35-28 for its first championship in school history. So we have had a lot going on here at GPB and more to come on the halftime show. We have to take a quick break, but stay right here. We're checking in with John, who has a special guest right after this. We'll be right back. decades of declining rates, tobacco use is on the rise, and vaping is growing in popularity among Georgia teens. Here to tell us more about this rising trend is Kylie McElvin from Cigna. Kylie, what is vaping, and why should parents be concerned if their kids are doing it?
So vaping and the use of electronic cigarettes have been on the rise. In fact, one in four Georgia teens say they've used an electronic cigarette in the past year. And most people understand that traditional cigarettes are dangerous. A lot of teens don't understand that vapes can be just as dangerous. They still contain high levels of nicotine, just like traditional cigarettes, and can be particularly impactful on a teenage brain that's still developing.
That's so true. Why are the rates of vaping going up among teens?
So a lot of teens mistakenly believe that vapes are safer than traditional cigarettes. They also see them as more socially acceptable, so there's not as much of a stigma around them. Also, the marketing that's targeted at e-cigarettes have been very targeted at teens, so colorful packaging, flavors that are appealing to young children.
What should parents do to help their kids kick the habit?
So the number one thing they can do is understand the why. Why is their teen vaping? Is it to act out? Is it because of peer pressure from their friends? Are they using vapes or other substances to help manage anxiety or maybe another mental health condition? Be sure to talk to your teen to understand why, and also make sure they're educated on the dangers.
Kylie, this is so important, especially during these times. So thank you for being here. And if you want to learn more, please go to Cigna.com.
The 2022 GHSA Football Championships are presented by this supporter of the GHSA, the Georgia Farm Bureau. Always the home team.
Record-breaking winds and rainfall defined
the area last night as an unexpected... Hey, Danny. Y'all make it through the storm last night? Don't worry, I'm on my way. Let's go to work, Lucky.
It's good to be lucky. It's better to have Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance.
We are a farm bureau.
A game without a crowd is just a scrimmage. A performance without an audience is just a rehearsal. Without your presence, high school sports and the performing arts aren't possible. Ensure that these essential extracurricular activities continue to enrich the lives of students in Georgia. Purchase a ticket to your local high school's game or performance.
This message presented by the GHSA.
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Welcome back. It's halftime of the GHSA 7A title game between Carrollton and Mill Creek. Let's head to Center Park Stadium, where John is standing by with Trojans principal Ian Lyle.
Yep, we're in a no-dilly-no-dally zone this time in the principal's office. What's it like seeing all of that support here in mid-December?
Oh, it's so special just to see our community come out. We are very blessed. We've got a great community, and it really starts at the top. Our superintendent, Dr. Mark Albertus, and our Board of Education, they're very supportive of everything that we do, and you can see the community support that's out here tonight as well.
What's the vibe been like this week getting ready to play in mid-December?
Yeah, very special just to honor the accomplishment of this team to get here. All of our kids, K through 12, have been very excited to support our kids for tonight.
So then last question for you, and thanks for hanging out, especially as it's starting to spit all over again. What else is going on at Carrollton High folks need to know about?
Well, you know, we're blessed that we really emphasize arts, academics, and athletics, and there's really always something going on. I think just this week I've attended a cybersecurity computer science competition, a band Christmas concert, a riflery match, and a dance showcase. So we've got a lot going on. We got something for everybody, and it's a great time to be a Carrollton Trojan in Carrollton, Georgia.
Thanks for coming down. Great to see you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
One trip to the principal's office down. Hannah, Mill Creek coming up in a bit.
Yeah, John, stick around. I want to get your thoughts on the first half real quick. What do you think about this score?
Oh, it's crazy. You know, we were talking about it. You know, 77 points. I am chasing Todd Holcomb at the Georgia High School Football Daily to find out what the record is for points and a half. So that request has been made. We'll see what we see. We'll see what we find out if we get an answer. If it's not like 90 or 400 or something.
All right, we'll hold you to it, John. So we want that answer soon. Thanks. Stay with us. More interviews in our GPP Play of the First Half next.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs. And we'll customize a plan.
Is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Welcome back to the Regions Halftime Show. I'm Hannah Gooden. If you're just now joining us, it's halftime of the GHSA 7A title game between Carrollton and Mill Creek. Here's our GPB play of the first half. We've been talking so much about Caleb Downs. Let's give the special team some love. First quarter, Carrollton set up for that 22-yard field goal attempt. It was blocked. Jamal Anderson is off. No one's going to catch him. 86-yard for a Hawks score. That set off an absolute touchdown frenzy by both teams. Blocked by Jaden Patterson, scooped up by Jamal Anderson. He is off. What a wild first half. Hawks head into the locker room with a 49. You heard that right. 49-28 lead. And that's not even the full story. Time now to go back to Center Park Stadium where John has the Mill Creek principal.
Yep, time to catch up with Friend of Football Friday's Jason Lane, who's got one of the coolest scarves that I've seen so far this weekend. That Mill Creek scarf was pretty sweet. What'd you say about the first half?
I said, that was an insane first half. Crazy.
What's it been like getting Mill Creek to be in the final game of the year? What's the week been like?
It's been really great. A lot of great things happen in our school between the band, the cheerleaders, and obviously with the football. The community's really rallied around them. It's been a great feeling at school.
And at the same time, I mean, Mill Creek nationally ranked in football. There's been a lot to be proud of. What else is going on at Mill Creek that folks need to be proud of?
I mean, obviously with our cheer program, they won the state championship again this year for the seventh time. We have a great epic STEM program at our school. And really just had a great year with all of our athletic programs. Band had a great competition this year too. So really proud of everything going on.
And at the same time, athletically, it's been all about family because Josh Lovelady's been there forever. Before that, it was the Jarvis family and Andy Dyer. Before he went to Archer, community and family have always been big at Mill Creek.
It really has. That's really bought into our culture pieces that Coach Lovelady has instilled this year. Obviously, the kids are very talented, but he's been preaching culture, the leadership pieces, and that goes way before Coach Lovelady. He's done a great job extending that piece. Just really, really proud.
Jason, thanks for your time. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. Thank you, John.
Now, one thing that I wanted to do before we send it back to the studio, couple of things. First and foremost, I want to send our love here at GPB to our friend Bob Rathman. Bob, we know what happened. We just wanted to send our love to Bob and hope that recovery is very, very speedy. We love you here at GPB. We just wanted to give you that shout-out. And one thing I also wanted to do is give a shout-out to the crew. Over the last 3 days, there have been a lot of waterlogged folks. Trust me, a lot of waterlogged folks that have made their way through here. And you're going to see a credit roll at the end of this weekend of a lot of massively talented folks that have been here at Center Park. They've been at 260 14th Street downtown, making sure that all of these pictures, all of the highlights, everything that you've seen has been fantastic and put into your living room, whether it's been over television, social media, all of the, you know, Twitter, Facebook, you name it. There are a lot of folks that made these 3 days happen. There's a lot of folks that made Football Fridays happen over this entire season here at 2022. It's one of the best seasons we've had where we've made some new barriers and done a whole lot of different things. I just personally wanted to make my own shout out to everybody here on this crew at GPB for everything that they've done. Everybody here, everybody there back at 260 14th Street, Hannah. Massive shout outs to everybody for a fantastic weekend in public broadcasting here on GPB.
Yeah, John, hang out with me for a second. So I want to give a shout out to for everybody here in this studio. We've been nice and dry, but producers Lori and Sammy, director Matt, Aisha, and Greg behind the camera, Bree, who makes me look pretty on camera, everybody here that is involved with this. It is a long haul. It is 3 days. We've almost been on the air for 35 hours, John. So tell me what's going on there at the field.
Well, you know, of course, the way the weekend started seems to be the way the weekend is ending. That's why I'm under the tent, and that's why I've changed from my suit coat into the puffy coat. I might go to the raincoat by the time that we're done. It will be interesting if the weather picks up and continues to do so, how the turf will react, how the players will react to it, the ball getting slippery. You could have turnovers. But the fact that we had 77 points in the first half with just two electric offenses, it's been a treat for the fan. I'm sure it's been just as nerve-wracking for the fans from both Mill Creek and Carrollton seeing all these points put up on the board. Second half, I hope, will be just as much of a treat.
All right, John, let's talk about the second half. What needs to happen with the Trojans' offense and their defense to stop Caleb Downs? What needs to happen on both sides of the ball for them?
Well, I mean, you take it from the Carrollton perspective, and they've got to steal some possessions. You saw the one interception Hayden Clark threw into the end zone, and Wayne Gandy said on the broadcast he was getting a little greedy, and so he threw into triple coverage, had the interception there. They couldn't quite take advantage of that possession. So you've got to steal some possessions here and there. You've got to be clinical with those possessions, because right now this is PS3. This is video game football, arena football. I've seen it mentioned a bunch of different ways. Carrollton has to steal possessions, and they've got to keep Mill Creek on their heels. They've got to get pressure on Hayden Clark and make sure that the running game to the edges is kept and contained for Mill Creek. It is pedal down. It is all gas, no brakes. You've done it for 24. You just need to do it for another 24. You get your first state championship ever.
Awesome, John. We can't wait for the second half. You go get ready, and I'll be talking to you very soon. Everyone, go follow us on social media at GBB Sports for constant updates throughout the GHSA Championships. Also, don't forget to take the games with you on the go by downloading the GBB Sports app. We're also streaming live at gbb.org/sports and Facebook. So that's it for the halftime show. Thanks for watching. That's it for me over these last 3 days. More from the second half of the Hawks versus the Trojans with Matt and Wayne, Nikki, John, right after this.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
As morning light signals the start of business, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are right there with you. Georgia's EMCs are a partner in economic development, serving commercial accounts big and small that drive Georgia's economy. From leading industries we rely on to local shops we treasure. We support operations on the ground, care around the clock, and growth through the seasons, lighting up good business. So business is good. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
Start of the third quarter coming up here at Center Park Stadium. Mill Creek, not a misprint. It's a 49-28 game at halftime here in Atlanta. Matt Stewart along with Wayne Gandy. Nikki Noto-Palmer going to catch up with Joey King in just a few moments. Let's take a look back. It's going to take us a while. So let's take a look back at the highlights here in the first half. Started with Big Cam Robinson streaking off on a long touchdown run.
Then the explosion just happened here. The field goal get blocked. Jamal Anderson with the long return for a touchdown.
That went 86 yards for the score. And then Juju Lewis got to work. Touchdown pass complete to Kai Kofer for the score. 27 yards right there. And the ensuing kickoff, Mikael Wood, 96 yards.
Big time special team touchdowns by Woods. And then Juju Lewis going back to work, back of the end zone here. Bryce Hicks down the sideline for the touchdown.
80 yards. Then it's time for Hayden Clark. He goes up top. Justin Content, they forgot about him. He goes 80 yards. And then the first of three touchdowns for Caleb Downs out of the Wildcat position. Finds the pylon. Juju Lewis back at work again. And this is Caleb Odom. Greco fell down, and then the stiff arm at the end of the play on Caleb Downs.
And Caleb Downs once again jumping into the end zone to get the second of his three touchdowns.
And then they run the trick play. And look at Caleb Downs. Stop on a dime, then sprint to the end zone and point at the defender. Third touchdown of the half for Caleb Downs. Juju Lewis not done yet. Back of the end zone to Kari Lipscomb. Sticks the landing. And 49-28 the score. As we get ready for the start of the third quarter, still only the special teams players out on the field. And slowly Carrollton coming out from their locker room in just kind of a thick mist, trying to become a fog settling down on top of this stadium. That might be the only thing that keeps anybody from scoring 100 tonight. They can't see the ball because the fog that's coming down. Let's send it down to Nikki.
Coach, Juju's got 357 yards, four touchdowns, but somehow we're still down by three. What more can you ask of your 15-year-old quarterback in your offense?
Oh, no, he's doing a great job. We're moving the ball and scoring points. We got to play better on special teams and on defense, not giving up big plays. I mean, we gave them two short yardage touchdowns there on poor execution, and then two special teams touchdowns. That's four scores. It's a three-score game, you know, so we still got a shot, but we're going to have to play a whole lot better second half.
Yeah, you guys are fighting. Mill Creek, they get the ball to start the half. How do you neutralize that offense and neutralize them fast?
That's a good question. That's what we just talked about. We got to fight. We got to fight like Trojans and play Trojan football. Got to make sure that our alignment assignment and execution is taken care of on the defense side of the ball. We're going to have to try to create some turnovers. They got a really good running game. They're going to try to pound a little bit probably to run this clock. We got to try to rip it out, get it back, and then take advantage of our opportunities.
Absolutely, and we've got the rain coming. What was their demeanor like in the locker room? What was your message to them?
They're good. I told them to fight like Trojans, and if they don't believe, don't come out of that tunnel. You know, a lot of things can happen, and what a story it would be to tell if we could come back from this one.
That's right. You'll chop that wood.
That's it. Chop wood. Go Trojans.
All right, Matt Wayne, the rain is officially coming down here on the field of Center Park Stadium. We got another foot race coming up in the second half.
Yeah, we'll see if the weather has any kind of an impact on our second half. And look at the numbers we have. Those look like college football total game numbers. It's high school football halftime numbers.
Six plays between the two teams, over 66 yards. It's just incredible. Both of these offenses are in a groove. And the defenses are just not able to keep up at this moment. I don't know where Carrollton goes in this second half defensively to try to slow down Cam Robinson and Caleb Downs and those guys.
Well, that's the $1 million question. What are they going to be able to do defensively to stop Mill Creek? We know Carrollton can score. Obviously, we know Mill Creek can score. But can Carrollton ever stop Mill Creek, which they have to do because they're three scores behind? They've got to come up with three stops and score all three times. No telling what the final score in this game is going to be, but we have 774 total yards combined between the two teams in 24 minutes of action. Here is just a rundown of the big plays. Cam Robinson, 66-yard rushing touchdown. Jamal Anderson, 88-yard block field goal touchdown. Mikael Wood, 96-yard kick return touchdown. Bryce Hicks, 80-yard touchdown reception. Justin Content, 80-yard touchdown reception. And Caleb Odom, 80-yard touchdown reception. Never seen a game in my life where I had three 80-yard touchdown receptions in the first half, much less the entire game.
This Carrollton offense said they were going to feast, especially down the field in those one-on-one matchups, and then just the explosive nature of the players for Mill Creek. An assortment of guys over there with Robinson, Downs, Woods, and those guys. They can take the ball from any distance for a touchdown.
So no telling what's going to happen here in the third quarter. Night continues to get chillier as we go on. And you can see the fog is socked in the capital city. Second half kickoff is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seatbelts save lives. Third quarter underway, non-returnable kick. Mill Creek will start the third quarter on offense from the 20-yard line.
We talked all about the skill positions and the impact, and rightfully so, that they've had in this game. But this Mill Creek offensive line, you got to give them a lot of credit. They have taken control, very little pressure on Hayden Clark, if any at all. And I expect them right now with Cam Robinson to try to chew into this clock by running the ball.
So Mill Creek already over 40 points, obviously. 12th time in 15 games they have done that this season. They go on offense. Clark, 4 of 7 passing for 144 and a touchdown in the first half. Going to go to the air again. It is caught by Mikel Wood, flagged down as Wood picks up close to 20, up to the 40.
In that area of holding right there in the middle of the field.
Ineligible downfield. Offense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, first down.
Love that look by Josh Lovelady. RPO game, that offensive line.
Call it
Hayden Clark, you got to get that ball out quicker.
They call it on Manny Marshall, the center. He was the one they threw the flag on. Clark off his back foot, dumps it off to Wood. Great open field tackle by Miles Butler.
Finally, a little pressure here. Jacob Ricks off the edge, getting Hayden Clark off his spot. Able to get the ball out with big-time tackle there by Butler. That's what this defense has to do. They got to rally to the ball, get some negative plays, and try to get the short field to the, and not just the short field, but get the ball back quickly to their offense.
Second and 16. Cam Robinson stuck at the line of scrimmage. Michael Braden and a host of others there, along with Brody Bradburn. Jacob Hicks. It's third down. This is a start. This is how you get back in the game. Starts with defense.
This job right there, getting upfield by Jay Farmer. One of the few times tonight we've seen some penetration by the D-line. Nowhere to cut that ball back for Robinson.
Third down and 15. Again, we had some people standing in front of the play clock at the other side of the field, so they had to get them out of the way.
Kind of all the work now, Carrollton. You got to get yourself, this defense got to get off the field. Doing a good job on this series of downs, forcing a third and long.
Going for the home run to Caleb Dale. Cannot connect.
Caleb Downs out on the edge, working against Quinn Ackey, showing you the speed, getting behind the defense here, outrunning Jaden Thompson, and just about a yard too far on that throw by Hayden Clark, or it would have been another touchdown for Caleb tonight.
Ulrich on the punt. He is standing at the 2-yard line.
False start. offense. 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
That'll back it up, and Ulrich will be punting out of his own end zone now.
And Jamil Creek, you got to come out with some energy. Set the tempo. You're kind of falling asleep, or you're going to let the Trojans back in.
I'm really in. They're playing them really short on this thing. Keyshawn Johnson, the return man's only standing at the 37. Ulrich gets it out of there and blasts it over his head. It lands at the 47 and rolls dead finally at the 43. 47-yard kick for Ulrich.
Can't be too comfortable if you're Mill Creek. That's just what Carrollton wanted to come out of the half and try to get off the field defensively very quick. Only took about 2 minutes off the clock. They already have the ball back for Juju Lewis.
Huge night for Juju Lewis. Four touchdowns already in this game.
Big question to start this half. What kind of adjustments in the secondary will Mill Creek make?
And Bryce Hicks down to the 43. 15-yard pickup for Bryce Hicks.
Good blocking right there. Nice job kicking out by the tight end. Jordan White, big hole. Look at the vision there of Bryce Hicks.
Going up top and intercepted at the 15-yard line. Greco with the pick. Odom was bracket coverage out there.
Really nowhere to go with this ball here for Juju Lewis. You feel like in this play, he just had already made up his mind that he was going to try to get this ball to Caleb Odom. As you can see, A.G. and Greco are back. Nowhere for that ball to fit in. Nice job of coming up with that interception is Greco.
Yeah, it looked like Odom lost it. Didn't look like he looked back and he looked like an outfielder who had lost a pop-up in the sky. He had no idea where the ball was. Cam Robinson bouncing to the outside. Going to pick up about four on the play.
Coach King trying to show his big receiver the mistake he made on that play. You can see him walking him through it.
Carries, 130 yards for Cam Robinson. Add to the total as he runs up to the 39-yard line.
Good job by Marshall, Sheen, Banfield in the middle of this line. Zone blocking. We've seen how effective they are running the ball. Brody Bradburn, inside linebacker, having to make that tackle, but not before Cam Robinson picked up the first down. And this is kind of what you felt like they were coming out to do in this second half. They didn't do it in that first series of downs where they threw the ball. But you imagine they're going to get this zone read game going and run.
Cam Robinson picks up a couple more yards. I would expect that Mill Creek and what we're seeing happen here at the start of this third quarter, they want to slow this thing down a little bit. They've got the big three-touchdown lead. By no means are they playing keep away, but they want to put together a long drive. Let's eat up this clock. Let's shorten this game and make it difficult for Carrollton to come back on us by trimming the clock.
Kevin Mitchell in the game at running back.
Quick fire out here to Mikel Wood. Stutter step, first down at the 46. 11-yard pickup.
Good job playing out on the edge. We talked about early in the game, they want to attack out on the edge. Just get the ball out to Wood, RPO game, ball out quick. That kind of talent. We talked about him out in open space picking up that first down.
He picked Eastern Michigan over four other offers, including Georgia Southern. The stunning statement there was he only had five offers. Obviously, they haven't watched enough of Mikael Wood, have they? Blitz is coming off the backside, and Clark is sacked. He never saw it coming. Got chased down from behind by Jace Ward, who's committed to Jackson State.
Big time pressure here by Ward. And if you're Hayden Clark, you got to feel that a little sooner. Coming unblocked is Ward on that play. Once again, deciding to throw the ball on first down. Had success running Robinson to start this drive. Really surprised there by Mill Creek throwing on first down.
Second and 16. Clark fires quickly to Wood. Wood spin move down to the 38.
Good job of Wood working to the inside. A lot of times smaller receivers don't want to go up into that area, but you can see the quickness. That's a little quick slant. Get the ball. So dangerous. So quick. Cuts on a dime is Woods.
That was Jace Ward who had the quarterback sack, then makes the tackle in coverage. Good-looking prospect, three-star linebacker. Cam Robinson slipped, trying to make a cut and get the first down. Goes down at the line of scrimmage, so now it's fourth down. Do you go for it here, or do you punt them deep?
To me, you send out Caleb Downs and that big body jumbo package in this situation. And I think that's exactly what they're going to do. The seven O-linemen and three tight ends.
So fourth and two going jumbo from the 38. And let's see. I don't know if he got it. The spot, he didn't get it. He did not get the first down on fourth and two. They stop Caleb Downs at the 37. Or did they? Now the spot that's on the field is different from the one we saw coming in from the sideline. So let's see exactly where they put the ball down.
It seemed like we have the linesman on one side has it a little further, a generous spot. They're going to bring out to measure.
It's a lot closer than I thought it was going to be based on my observation of the linesman on the opposite side. And they missed it. Carrollton gets a stop.
Just by inches right there. Big break for Carrollton to stop that drive. Mill Creek was eating up some time, moving the ball.
So the Trojans going back on offense after they get a big play on defense.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs. And we'll customize a plan.
The HDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org. Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
Football.
49-28, Mill Creek just got stopped on downs. Caleb Down got stopped on downs, and now Carrollton goes out there on offense. I know it's shocking, but we've played nearly 7 minutes in this quarter without anybody scoring.
And this offense of Carrollton on this drive has to go down and get a touchdown. They're not going to get many more shots. And they can't expect their defense to hold this offense off too much longer.
No, you're exactly right. Time is now a factor in this game, even though we still have
timeout for injury.
5 minutes left in the third quarter.
Josh Anglin, it's like maybe a cramp. We saw a couple of players last night in the game we televised having a lot of cramp issues as well.
It was much warmer yesterday than it is today. And then the opening night on Thursday night was warmer than that. It's been a weird weather week here, unseasonably warm weather. This is closer to being what you would think for December 10th here. Although certainly we've had state championship games in this range of dates where we've had snow. Famously shutting down the state championships when they were being played at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. The very first year.
It's like he's struggling to get up there, trying to get that water, the old water trick that never works. What a season that young man has had for this team. Josh Anglin.
Their leading tackler.
Leading tackler.
Six-foot-2, 12 junior, also leads the team in tackles for loss, not just total tackles, but also TFLs.
Big production in the middle of that defense between Anglin and Mullen, both only juniors, so we'll be back next year. Spreading out once again is Carrollton. We talked about they're going to continue to work these one-on-one matchups and test these corners of Mill Creek.
Second down and 7. Lewis guns it in the middle. It's complete at the 50-yard line. And Takari Lipscomb, the Arkansas State commit, with the first down catch.
Nice job there by Lipscomb, just settling down in the middle of that zone here as the young freshman goes through his route. Good protection. That play took a long time. No pressure right there. Just settle down right in front of Caleb Downs and make the catch.
Lewis going far side and incomplete, trying to connect with Kofer. And Jaden Patterson, the free safety, was running coverage there.
Cole Mullen with the pressure once again. Having to rush that throw right there is Juju Lewis. When given protection, given time, and I think that was the adjustment Coach King made as well, offensive coordinator Reggie Perkins, on those little rollouts to get away from pressure from that defensive line.
Lewis is at 403 yards passing. Pressure coming right up the middle. They run a screen to Hicks. Hicks got a block inside the 40, inside the 30, inside the 20. Cutback. There he goes. Bryce Hicks, 49-yard touchdown. Catch and run.
What a big season. What a big-time player. What an impact this young man. The best football player at Carrollton has. Screen pass. Great job of concentration just to bring the ball in, and then it just becomes a joystick video game type moves out in the open field. Vision, cutting ability, and speed to the end zone.
Second receiving touchdown of the night for Bryce Hicks. A 49-yarder to go with his 80-yarder, and it's 49-35.
Taking the field, felt like this was a must-have touchdown drive to get this game closer. Bryce Hicks, good blocking by the O-line. And then just watch this young man work out in the open field, making people miss and showing you a speed I think very few people knew he possessed when the season started. But he has shown up, as we say, and shown out each and every time we put him on TV.
And amazingly enough, he only has 4 offers, including Coastal Carolina, Liberty, and Eastern Michigan.
Only a junior, you expect. From what the body of work he's put together this year, Matt, as I always tell you, I don't know what the stars mean, but he's shown at least a three-star type ability this year to us GPB audience alone.
I will tell you this. This is what I've figured out. Sometimes the stars mean a lot, and sometimes they mean nothing. Is that a good enough answer? Sometimes, yep, he's a five-star, and sometimes, nope, he's not. Let's send it down to Nikki.
Matt Wayne, that is exactly the play that Joey King was looking for. The fans in the stands, they have yet to sit down. They're screaming. The guys on the sideline, they go, we got one, baby. Let's keep this thing going. We got to fight, fight, fight. The sideline has lit up after that play. Hopefully they can sustain this momentum.
And the next touchdown that we have scored in this game will tie us for the highest scoring game in state championship history. And Carrollton was involved in the highest scoring game ever back in 2013 when they lost to Griffin. Pass across the middle. Incomplete.
Nice route here by Braden Jenkins on Quinn Akey, and that's just Hayden Clark. Got to settle your feet and make that throw. Jenkins on that slant comes wide open, and Clark just missed him.
So we're at 84 total points right now. The highest is the 91 when Griffin beat Carrollton 56-35 in the 2013 state championship game. Hayden Clark got hit as he threw, complete to the Wood. And up to the 26-yard line, he lunges. It's going to be third down. Clark took a real shot at the end of that play.
Nice job by Wood. Strong hands here. Watch Hayden Clark. Big hit. Delivered the ball. Caleb Downs out on the edge blocking, but great concentration there by Mikhail Wood.
Third down and four. If Carrollton can get a stop here, it may be on. Hand off Cam Robinson. Not only did they not get a stop, Cam Robinson is down to the 30-yard line.
Great cut back here by Cam Robinson. Nowhere to go on that zone, blocking to the left. Weaving through traffic. Big plays all around for that young man tonight. Just once again, good blocking right there. Jeremiah Sheen driving the D lineman down, getting a pancake, taking advantage of it is Cam Robinson.
184 yards rushing for Cam Robinson tonight. And Moore stumbles forward for 8 yards.
Holding out on the edge on Montrez Smith.
And a man down for Carrollton as well.
Jacob Levy, holding. Number 51.
Offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay, first down.
So that is Jacob Levy, who looked like he was having some cramp issues. Penalty against Mill Creek will wipe out that run by Cam Robinson. Josh Lovelady, Joey King, pleasure to work with both of these guys over the course of the season. They're great. Give us a lot of information. We appreciate working with these guys. Josh, of course, got emotional when they got to the state championship game last week, beating Milton in the semifinals. He's been there all 19 years the school's been in existence. Cam Robinson, so elusive.
Matt, when they talk about cutting on the dime, they should put this play up when Cam Robinson stops on Miles Butler to get to the backside. Watch as he cuts this ball back. Miles Butler is going to come up. Look at that cut. Shook him out of his shoes for finishing that run. Just a great first game we interviewed. Coach Lovelady has so many questions. Didn't really know whether Cam Robinson could hold that job down, and he is. You would have never known he was a slot receiver, the performance he's put together this year.
natural-born running back. This time, he's caught back there. Got a block from the quarterback. How about the block that Hayden Clark just threw to Springing?
Always have to be alert with Caleb Downs with the ball in his hands. Nowhere to go. Good penetration up the field by Butler. Cut back, and Hayden Clark decided, who's a big quarterback at 6'1", about 205, hitting Michael Braden right there to spring his star running back, Caleb Downs.
Yeah, now he's over on the sideline with some cramp issues himself. Handoff, Cam Robinson. Robinson shoved out of bounds by Bradburn, close to the first down marker. I'm wondering, I mean, I've never seen this many cramp issues this late in the year. I think it has to do with the fluctuation. They've been in the temperature. They've been used to playing in cold weather, and then all of a sudden it got warm again.
Several players down. Nice block on that last zone blocking by Cole Mullen. Hard count drawing Miles Butler offside.
And I'm not implying
defense after distance to the goal. Still first down.
That the weather has anything to do with the cramp. I just think, you know, the colder it gets, maybe you hydrate less. And so you've been hydrating less, and now all of a sudden you need to hydrate more because it's warmer. In the express red zone, that certainly isn't a scientific explanation, just my observation. Right or wrong. First and goal. Robinson slipped, trying to make a cut. Saw a hole in that line. Was going to try to cut through it.
Look at it. Robinson there. Zone blocking. Good blocks up there by the O line. Cole Mullen, he slipped. And you can see Cam Robinson waving off Caleb Down package. If you're trying to figure out what he's telling everybody, he's putting up two fingers and waving it off like, no, I'm staying in the game and getting this touchdown.
A 200-yard rushing night for Cam Robinson. Hand off to him. Touchdown. Second rushing touchdown of the night for Cam Robinson.
Cam Robinson, not just a dynamic player, but also the offensive coordinator on this play. He decided to call his own number, getting in the end zone, a walk-in touchdown. Well-deserved big run by him to get everything started on that drive.
And Ulrich on for the PAT. And this has officially tied for the highest scoring game in Georgia High School Association State Championship history. A 56-35 score, and we still have about 14 minutes to play. And it's already matched the 2013 state championship game that finished with this same score when Griffin beat Carrollton.
What an answer by Mill Creek right there, right when you felt like Carrollton maybe be getting back into this game with their touchdown, taking that ball, driving down the field. That young man making major plays on that drive. Touchdown run for him as well.
He wanted to stay in and get the touchdown. And the coaches accommodated him.
Waving it off. No more of that gold, too. I'm staying on the field.
So back to a 21-point lead for Mill Creek, trying to win their first ever state championship game in their first ever attempt. This is the 14th all-time state championship game for Carrollton. And they've won seven of them. Ball goes into the end zone, will not be returned. But it's been a long time for Carrollton, and that's why they hired Joey King to get them back to the promised land. They played in the state championship game in 2010 and 2013 when Joey was the offensive coordinator before he left to take the Cartersville job. They won it last in 1998. That is their only state championship since then, and it's their only one in the last 47 years. All their other state championships came back starting in 1956 through 1974. Pass complete to Odom, and he'll dive forward to the 48-yard line. And Joey King at Cartersville, that's where he established himself as one of the best coaches in the state. Won two state championships and played for another. And that's after he had been the offensive coordinator at Carrollton.
The confusion here. Caleb Odom, not sure which side of the ball he's supposed to be on.
They'll whip it back there. That's a backwards pass. That's a live ball, and they're going to spot it out at the 31.
Lucky break here for Carrollton that the ball went out of bounds. Nice.
Going on the field is an incomplete pass.
Oh, wow. That certainly looked like a backward pass and a run.
Trying to get the ball out in space to Bryce Hicks out on the edge. Nice read there by Langston Agee. You can see.
Okay, so the pass here from the 35, it hits his hands. You know, at the 30, it's close. They dodged a bullet.
This Mill Creek defense, just tremendous pressure up the field. But Juju Lewis and this passing attack has just been wonderful against it.
Hicks up to the 41-yard line.
Caleb Downs back in the game. Nice tackle right there by him. We've seen him do so much tonight. Sometimes you forget everything that's Caleb Downs starts from the safety position. That's what he's most likely going to end up being at the next level down in Tuscaloosa. If that's where he continues to choose to go.
Right there in the middle. Couldn't come up with it. Incomplete.
Nice job there by Cole Mullins, the linebacker, falling back into that play. Takari Lipscomb making a business decision right there. Caught in between Mullins and Patterson.
Fourth and five. You got 13 minutes left in the game. You're down three scores. You're going for it, right?
You have to go for it right here and trust your young quarterback to get it done. Your defense just has not been able to stop Mill Creek.
Throw back inside. Screen, and it's blown up. Agee takes down Hicks. Ball goes over on downs.
Great read here by Langston Agee, the senior. Little tunnel screen, getting the ball out here. The
at Childers.
Childers, big tackle. Watch how he breaks on this ball. Nice job. No face mask, ball up, arm up high, but it was on the shoulder pad right there. Nice tackle by Langston Agee, number 30.
Four tackles, a TFL. That TFL coming right there. That was big. And now the ball goes over to Mill Creek at the 37-yard line. Robinson dances outside. Shoved out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Jaden Thompson got to him to save a touchdown.
Once again, showing you the vision, showing you the ability to cut back in the hole, showing you the explosion. Cam Robinson, dynamic, came into this game with over eight games of 100-yard plus. Just outstanding season. His vision is just next level, how he's seeing those cutback lanes.
229 yards rushing for Robinson. Robinson down to the 15-yard line, the 14-yard line. And another score right here makes it almost mathematically impossible for a Carrollton comeback.
eating up the clock, shortening the game, and trying to put more points on the scoreboard. Caleb Downs in the game at running back.
Second down and 7. Complete. Jenkins down to the 5, and that's a first down.
Nice job there by Brendan Jenkins. Knowing where the sticks are, settling down in front of the safety here, working out of the slot, catch the ball, secure catch, picking up that first down.
And that is the end
of
the third quarter. Tied for the highest scoring state championship game in Georgia history. We have had a lot of fireworks. One quarter to go to decide the 7A state champion.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDV and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign. Celebrate life, live drug-free.
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your thirst, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Respect. It's more than a word. In the U.S. Army, respect is earned every day. Now, in addition to earning respect, you may qualify for more. Information at goarmy.com/bonus or 800-USA-ARMY. Paid for by the U.S. Army.
Start of the fourth quarter, 56-35 lead for Mill Creek. Buckle up, Georgia. Want to say thanks for the entire GPB crew to Brian Dill, our chairman of the board, Georgia Public Broadcasting. He's from Carrollton. Want to say thanks for giving us this wonderful privilege and opportunity to call the state championship games here at Georgia State. It has been a blast for the last 3 days. And Mill Creek, first and goal to go from the 5. Cam Robinson looking to get another touchdown. Picks up 2 yards right there.
This Mill Creek team has just been at the next level. They lost to Buford. And from that loss on, they just decimated the competition to find themselves once again down on the goal line trying to seal this state championship game.
Cam Robinson trots into the end zone. Third rushing touchdown of the night for Cam Robinson. And that breaks the all-time scoring record for a state championship game. We have 97 combined points at 62-35.
Great job by the offensive line. A walk-in touchdown on that for Cam Robinson.
Ulrich up and good, 63-35.
Just zone read blocking, cutback ability right there. You can see Robinson going in the end zone untouched for his third of the night.
4 plays, 37 yards. After the failed fourth down conversion for Carrollton. And how about that? You've got 2 players for Mill Creek tonight who have scored 3 touchdowns in the game. Caleb Downs has three. Cam Robinson has three. Look at the numbers. Extraordinary effort here tonight. Cam Robinson.
10 yards a carry by that young man. Big runs, a lot of tough runs inside as well. As we talked about, these aren't just outside runs. A lot of them in between the tackles.
And the kick again, non-returnable. Carrollton has not had a kick return tonight. On a night when there's been a bunch of kick return opportunities, Ulrich has been 100% on touchbacks.
Jacob Ulrich, big season. Be back next year as well. Excuse me, he is a senior. He'd be gone, but his offer should rise up after this game. Big leg.
I would certainly think that he's got a Power 5 opportunity out there somewhere. Lewis scanning the field, throwing, and complete to Childers at the 21. Luke Metz making the tackle.
Got to work quick. Scoreboard really doesn't say you're going to have a chance to win this game, but this Carrollton team, Joey King talked about Trojan football. They're going to keep fighting.
Second and 9, complete to Childers again. Breaks a tackle. Shoved out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
Nice job of Childers stopping for this ball. Trajan Greco just missing up on the timing there. Childers doing a good job stopping, bringing that ball in, and yak after the catch.
It's a 23-yard pickup. Catch, shove out of bounds, and they will rule that a catch. Yep, the ball came out after he hit the ground. And Caleb Odom with the catch.
It's a simple out route once again. Caleb Odom working against Greco. Good protection, play action fake. Getting the toes down.
Lewis has now thrown for 508 yards tonight. And nearly picked. Content, who already had one pick today, nearly had another.
And Bryce Hicks never got his head around. Don't really think he felt like that ball was coming to him on this play. We saw him score on something like this earlier, and by the time he turned his head around, the defender broke on the ball, almost an interception there by Greco.
Second down and 10. Setting up a screen to Hicks. And he'll go down at the 46.
Nice job that time by Cole Mullen sniffing that out. They've been beat by that screen play for some big yardage tonight. You see number 6. He sees it this time, getting out there, making Hicks cut back into traffic. Langston Angie coming down with the tackle.
Third down and 10 from the 46. Lewis throws, and it's complete to Lipscomb. That's a first down. Breaks a tackle, and Lipscomb finally down to the 21-yard line. Great effort by Takari Lipscomb, making his third catch of the game.
Lewis rolling out to his right. Once again, throwing on the run. Nice grab there by Lipscomb. Look at him fight, as we talked about. This team is going to fight to the end. That's how they got here. That's how they play. That's how they are coached by Coach King.
First and 10. Lewis backpedaling and throwing, overthrows Odom.
Juju Lewis, superb night. ...142 yards in the second half. Looks small compared to the work he did in the first half, but he's fighting. He's had a brilliant night. He's been playing from behind the entire night here, trying to get his team once again in the end zone.
Over 520 yards passing in this game. Pass complete to Childers. And Childers will throw a flag on that. That'll be a face mask.
Langston, AG 30 right there, just reaching out, trying to get the tackle. Ended up grabbing the face mask here. See, just quick route.
Personal foul, face mask, defense. After this is to the goal, results in a first and 10.
Didn't really look
really
like
from that.
Looked like maybe more of a horse collar tackle than a face mask.
Yeah,
looked like they grabbed the inside of his shoulder pads, but not the face mask. Either way, it would have been a penalty. I think it's just a different penalty than the one that they called down on the field. Trojans in the express red zone. It's first and goal to go. Running a tunnel screen in there. It's complete. And Odom down to the 4-yard line. That'll be the 7th catch of the game for Odom. So he's got 7 catches. Hicks has 6, and Childers has 6.
The tunnel screen here. Good job setting it up. Get it to his big target. Greco trying to script the ball. Odom fighting for each and every yard, trying to get in the end zone. The screen game has been so productive for this offense tonight.
Second down and goal. Hicks gets 1 yard on the play before being driven back. Lewis is at 544 yards passing in this game. To keep it in perspective, the most yards passing in an NFL game ever, 554 by Norm Van Brocklin. The LA Rams, of course, that was in 1951, and Norm Van Brocklin would end up coaching across the stadium that, across the street where the stadium that he was the head coach of the Atlanta Falcons in the old Atlanta Fulton County Stadium. And here, right around the block, this young man, a freshman in high school, is about to throw for more yards than he ever did in an NFL game.
Cole Mullins with the pressure right there on Juju Lewis, trying to find Jordan White in the back of the end zone. And on this drive, this Carrollton team, they're making yards, but they're not really striking quick to get this ball in the end zone, try to make a comeback.
Yeah, play clock is at 4. Big sack back at the 14-yard line. Jamal Anderson. Ball goes over on downs as Jamal Anderson gets the quarterback sack.
Is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Record-breaking winds and rainfalls defined the area last night as an unexpected...
Hey, Danny. Y'all make it through the storm last night? Don't worry. I'm on my way. Let's go to work, Lucky.
It's good to be lucky. It's better to have Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance.
Our number one priority is protecting our players. That's why we're writing new rules for the sport and developing innovative educational tools that protect our athletes. This is player protection. This is high school football.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to...
7:36 left in this one. Mill Creek 63-35 lead on Carrollton, and now the Hawks will take over. You would think they're just going to put this ball on the ground and try to finish this game off and take a lot of time off the clock. They do give it to Cam Robinson, and he picks up a couple of yards on the play. Mill Creek, the most points they ever scored in a game. Back in 2014, they scored 65 against West Forsyth. And here in the state championship game, they're 3 points away from breaking that.
What a time to break records is in this game here. And they have their heavy package in right now. Two tight ends. They're going to milk this clock. Caleb Downs back at running back.
Yeah, this is the thing to do right here. Caleb Downs plows in there, gets a couple of yards. I mean, you've already got enough points to win the game. What you really need right now is just to keep getting consistent 3 and 4 yards and take time off the clock and win the championship.
Yeah, just move the chains, get a couple of first downs. You can see they're going to line up at the line, watch the sideline. They know the play. Typically in these situations, you go into your 4-minute offense. You run that same exact play on different sides.
You know, and this is a run by Caleb Downs and a first down, and he goes down at the 26. And you know, you'll hear sometimes coaches say, well, our goal, our point is to score points. Well, yeah, to score enough points to win. The ultimate goal is just to win, right? Whether that's 3 points or 66 points, whatever it takes for you to win, that's how many you need to score. And so you'll see sometimes coaches in this situation, well, we just keep throwing the ball, which might actually be detrimental to their effort to win the game. But Mill Creek doing exactly what you should do in this situation. I think the big question here with them going to the ground game in these final 5 minutes, how many yards can Cam Robinson finish with?
Nice job running that outside zone play once again over there behind Bothwell. Aiden Banfield, the 3-star, has had a great season this year for them, number 68.
Yep.
And this offensive line has done a great job. They get a lot of credit. When they need to run the ball, they have the ability up there to move the pile.
2nd down and 2. Another first down run for Cam Robinson. He goes over 250 in the game with that run right there.
Looks like he might have a cramp going on as well. He's done a lot of work here. Little counter play. Good kick out there by Banfield. Just keeping the sticks move. Picked up another first down.
He'll come off the field at 253. And Caleb Downs will come back on. Downs gets the handoff. Dives forward. He understands what's going on.
No need to take unnecessary hits. Nice job securing the ball. Early in the game, he might have tried to bounce that all the way back. That time, doing the smart thing. Just get down. Don't need to fumble the ball.
Now Kevin Mitchell will check in at running back. Under 4 minutes to go until Mill Creek will win their first ever state championship. Going to run the clock all the way down to 4:03. They snap it. And Kevin Mitchell picks up about 10 on the play.
Just an impressive season by Mill Creek. The body of work speaks for itself. These kids, each phase of their offense, their defense, key special team plays as well. And these seniors on this team really bought in and shined, like Downs and Anderson, those guys, leaders.
They will finish the year 14-1, best record ever in Mill Creek history. They had a couple of 13-1s back in 2015 and 2016 when they got stopped in the semifinals. But 14-1 here in year 19, and they win the state championship. Josh Lovelady came with Shannon Jarvis to start the program back then in 2004. They both had been working at, well, Josh had been working at South Gwinnett with T. McFerrin.
Good clock management on this drive to end this game. On their ninth play of this drive, already have taken off 5+ minutes.
And I know Josh, when he starts thinking back, Kevin Mitchell off to the races, and he's going to score another touchdown. Kevin Mitchell, 48-yard touchdown run. The highest scoring game in Mill Creek history comes in their biggest game ever in Mill Creek history.
Outside zone, once again, being able to get to the outside. Kevin Mitchell, known more for a power back, showing you the speed right there for a memorable touchdown of his high school career.
70-35. And Josh Lovelady with the hugs.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
Every game day celebration, every championship title begins here with hours of unseen work. As part of our commitment to education, Georgia's EMCs support the young athletes who play high school sports in the communities we serve. Empowering talent with scholarships, honoring sportsmanship, saluting the game changers. When we champion the energy behind the scenes, they can step into their future and shine. Georgia's EMCs, official energy provider of the GHSA.
I've been checking food labels for years. I like to buy local, and I like to buy healthy for my family. So I started checking the labels on our clothes, too. Did you know synthetic fibers like polyester are pretty much made of oil? No thanks. I look for cotton now, which grows right here in Georgia, a major source of the world's cotton. Cotton is natural, renewable, sustainable, and buying cotton supports Georgia farmers. Good enough for me and my family.
Be on the lookout for GPB in your community. From events for the entire family to exclusive screening and premieres, GPB has you covered. Don't miss out. Check gpb.org/community each month for the latest events.
We've covered Mill Creek a few times this season, and whenever we ask Coach Lovelady to describe this team, he says this is the most unselfish bunch of guys, and it's really special watching how they love their teammates. And when I asked him what winning a state championship would mean to him, guys, he got super choked up. The only word he could get out was wonderful. He composed himself and he said, hey, if we win, it's only going to add to the legacy and the greatness of the program that we're trying to build right here. We're trying to do it the right way, and it looks like they're on their way.
Just an extraordinary performance by the Mill Creek Hawks tonight. His mom and dad back in Kansas couldn't be here tonight, but they're watching on television. And I know they're having a big old party in Western Kansas tonight in the Lovelady household to celebrate this state championship. Your son has won the title.
Matt, I wonder if Coach can Does he have to ask Caleb, can they have a party now? Does he?
I think even Caleb will relent and have a party now. The mission has been accomplished.
And Nikki is right. As soon as she asked him about winning a championship, he really paused and had to get himself together on the interview to hold the tears back. He is all in on this Mill Creek Hawk team. What a great moment for him.
Carrollton goes back on offense. And we're down to 93 seconds to go.
False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Tough way for Carrollton to wrap things up, but an extraordinary 14-1 season for them, too. And Joey King, just his third loss in 2 years as the Trojans head coach. And they've got the number one freshman quarterback, who next year will be the number one sophomore quarterback in the nation running their program.
Juju Lewis and his skill set makes this team dangerous. Bryce Hicks as well. These guys, quite sure they're going to use that as motivation going into the next season. Great job is Joey King getting this program back to prominence. The O-line is over there hugging. I don't know if that's like, I don't know. We don't really do a lot of bro hug in the O-line, but hey, it's state championship time. Go for it, guys.
Bryce Hicks. Phenomenal night for Bryce Hicks, and he'll be back. Thinking that Carrollton will be ranked number one in the preseason rankings, don't you think?
Guy Gift Dudley, they got Sizemore, Kofor coming back as well. Jordan White, they got a lot of talent. Caleb Odom, the receiving core, so.
We won't miss on them this time. Lewis going up top for Odom. Can't call it in. And it's fourth down. I thought Josh was getting ready to hug the referee. The official walking by. He's hugging everybody.
Everybody's going to get a hug tonight.
Even the officials.
Just saw Hayden Clark. What a season he had as well.
Absolutely.
We didn't have to talk much about his season, but he is a tremendous game manager, plays with confidence, really led this team from the quarterback position.
On fourth down, they're just going to run it here to Jamon Evans, and he's going to go down. And that'll be the final offensive play that Carrollton runs here in 2022. 31 seconds on the clock, and Mill Creek will go out there and take a knee and finish this one off. And Hayden Clark certainly hope the recruiting thing works out for him. I know he would dearly love to continue playing football at the next level. Solid 3-year starter. Hope he gets that opportunity. Does have a couple of offers. Hope he gets what he wants.
Celebration. The fans are already ready to storm the field. Great turnout here by Mill Creek and their fans.
You see a lot of the Mill Creek alumni, guys who played there over the last 19 years, on the sideline to celebrate this historic moment. The Mill Creek Hawks are the 2022 state champions.
Just a great sight to see the jubilation of Mill Creek. Those players, what an effort dominance they've shown here this season.
And the trophy awaits the Mill Creek Hawks. And it starts raining. Won't dampen the celebration by any means. Caleb Downs giving interviews. Get used to doing that.
What a fantastic young man. True leader. And lived up to everything we thought he would bring to the football field.
Laser focused on the job at hand. Could have gone to IMG, could have gone anywhere he wanted to in the country. Josh Lovelady knew that, but he told everybody that would broach that subject with him that I am a Mill Creek Hawk. I started my career here. I want to finish my career here with my friends. And he finishes it with a state championship. And look at all the little young men crowded around Caleb down, starry-eyed, looking at the superstar.
Got to get my YouTube up, Matt. I got a little TikTok. Caleb Downs, state championship. What a big moment.
No doubt. It's a tight community, a great football system up there, and a lot of those little boys that you see looking at Caleb Downs, staring at him, are hoping one day they're going to be in that same spot. That's a beautiful scene down there. Let's go down to John Nelson.
Thank you very much, Matt Stewart. I'm going to call the siren call for Josh Lovelady. Josh Lovelady, you have a trophy waiting for you here at the 50. Fantastic work in the 19th season for Mill Creek. And here comes Josh. It's time to present a championship trophy here in 7A, and to do it here in the rain, once again, it's the executive director of the Georgia High School Association, Dr. Robin Hines, and our friends from Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance, Dr. Hines.
Thank you. First, I'd like to congratulate Carrollton on a great season. Great job from Coach King and his staff, and his kids were awesome. Also want to congratulate the Carrollton community for the way they support their kids. Job well done. But right now, Coach, we're talking about the first state championship in football for Mill Creek. I don't know that I've ever seen a game like this. I don't know if I expected a game like this, but it certainly turned out in your favor. Your kids played really hard. How are you feeling about your kids tonight?
Oh, I feel wonderful. You know, it was all three phases of the game. We preach that. Special teams, defense, offense. I'm just so proud of them. You know, they're such an unselfish group. It doesn't matter about size, weight, or anything like that. They just want to go play and have fun and win.
Well, Coach, I'm going to tell you, I'm really proud of you. You're one of the good guys, and it gives me great pleasure on behalf of the Georgia High School Association to present you with this state championship trophy.
Easiest question you will ever have. How does it feel?
It feels wonderful. But you know what? It ain't about me. It ain't about these kids. It's about everything. You know what I'm saying? 19 years of a culture being built. We grow our kids from youth all the way up. They buy into our process, into our fundamentals, and our culture. And golly, our leadership at our school is awesome. You can hear the crowd. They were behind us. I'm just so excited.
This group of seniors, very, very special group. What comes to mind when I mention this particular group that will be leaving and heading to the college ranks after this?
Legacy.
they left a mark, and it's a very strong mark as far as what they do and how they go about their business. And I just hope these young guys can learn from the way they go about their business.
Think back to day one for me when you were first at Mill Creek and everything that has gone in the path with you and the Jarvises and the Dyers and all those names that have been helping build Mill Creek to where it is now. You're going to think about how the road has finally given you to the last game of the year?
It's been a long journey with so many people. You talk about, I probably had 100 alumni reaching out that were just pulling from us, whether it's here, all the way from Oregon to New York. And the coaches, heck, the wives and the families that had to sacrifice for all that time, you can't put words on how much commitment we've had from our community, our touchdown club, everything else that made this happen.
And your parents in Western Kansas, I believe.
Yeah, my parents in Kansas. They're having a little watch party.
Congratulations, my friend.
Thank you.
Mill Creek state champs in 7A. Matt Stewart will be back with Cam Robinson in just a little bit.
So fun to watch Josh Lovelady soak in the moment.
Seems like he had a million thoughts in his head as he was trying to talk right there. I think John was trying to bait him as well into a little tear
yeah,
to come down. He was pressing on that button. Good for Coach. He held it off. But I'm quite sure they're going to come out at some point here tonight.
Well, you and I have worked two games here. Three games here, two of the last two nights, and five total for me. Three first-time state champions out of the five games I called. Mill Creek, Langston Hughes, and, of course, Ware County earlier today. Three first-time state champions. All of them waited their turn and battled through it. It's an extraordinary night when you win it for the first time. And the celebration continues. They're posing for their pictures. And let's send it back down to John Nelson with our Cotton Commission Player of the Game.
And I know that you've got some celebrating to do, Cam, so we'll make this kind of quick. What was it like out there tonight? It was almost video game stuff.
It was amazing. It was ridiculous. I was not expecting the score to be like this. Carrollton's a great team. They have a great coaching staff. But Coach Love told us from day one that if we play with our heart and we play with each other, we're going to get a championship. And that's what we did tonight.
When you look back at this year and the success that Mill Creek has had, it almost seems too easy at times. Talk about the hard work that it took to get to this game and win the last game of the year.
All the summer workouts, all the spring workouts, all the ups and downs we went through as a team, finding ourselves after that Buford loss really humbled us. And after that, we just been on the roll. Yeah.
And I'm going to hang on to this so it doesn't fall because it's got enough of those pellets on there. When you look at this group of folks that have been around you, I know that family has been thrown around as a word.
Yes, sir.
Break down the brotherhood for me.
One of a kind. These are going to be my brothers forever.
Hey, let's go, Cam.
I couldn't do anything without him.
27-252-3. That's why he's the Georgia Cotton Commission Player of the Game. The Cotton Commission, natural choice for Georgia. Cam was our natural choice for Player of the Game. Matt Stewart, put a bow on the weekend. Send us home before we all wash away.
All right. Thank you, Nelly. Congratulations, Cam, and to the Mill Creek Hawks. Wayne, extraordinary game for the ages type performance here tonight as they win it 70-35.
It was definitely a privilege to call this game, witness it, and see a first half by both of these teams that we'll remember forever.
And we saw a glimpse of the future, too, even in defeat for Carrollton, as Juju Lewis put up 531 in passing as a ninth grader.
Something tells me that that young man at Carrollton is going to bring a trophy at some point in his high school career.
That's going to put a wrap on our eight state championships, the three flag football championships, the three great days of Georgia High School football championship game coverage right here on GPB, and our entire season going all the way back to August. The games, recruiting 2022 countdown to kickoff, and we will have a National Signing Day special for you coming up in a couple of weeks. Here's a list of all the extraordinary people, talented people who are behind the scenes who make Football Fridays in Georgia possible. We couldn't do it without any of them. They are the true stars. 70-35, the final. Mill Creek State Championship for the first time ever. And now for Wayne Gandy, my statistician, Kevin Barnes, Nikki Noto Palmer on the sidelines, Glenn Diamond, our producer, our director, A.J. Keene, and all these people, great, talented people. I'm Matt Stewart. Good night. Thanks for joining us in 2022. We're already looking forward to 2023.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your best, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Palmer!
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.